Hi guys, and welcome back to another Minecraft tutorial. Today we're going to be learning how to build the USS Arizona, the Pennsylvania-class battleship. So of course most people do know it as the USS Arizona, this one especially. So it's a pretty big build. It's 190 blocks long, 57 high, and 31 wide. So it is going to be quite a long tutorial, and this is going to be a pretty advanced tutorial as it's got my kind of new way of building ships, which, as you can see, if we kind of come onto here, you can see that it's kind of got a lot of complex curves and things like that in it. So it's not going to be anywhere near as easy as my last Battlefield tutorial. So I'm just going to fly it over the map while talking to you guys about what you can expect from this tutorial. So it is going to be a layer-by-layer tutorial. I've just found that this is the easiest way to actually teach you guys how to build these ships. And also, if, for example, you wanted to stop at layer number 3, I always announce the layers, so I'll be, you know, after you've done this one, you can kind of quickly find where you were in the video to actually rejoin it. So like I said before, this is going to be a really advanced tutorial. This is a pretty difficult ship. It took me absolutely ages to actually build, just because the shapes in it are a little bit like different, as you can actually see the kind of weird curves that go onto each side. But hopefully it shouldn't take you guys too long. It'll probably be one of my longer tutorials that I've done so far. If you do use this on a map or server, make sure that you credit me for the design itself. So what I mean by this is make sure that you put a sign up saying designed by Lord Dakar, and don't hide it somewhere in a ridiculous, do put it where you can actually see it. So we're just going to come to the end of where I'm actually going to be counting off, and then it'll be the rest of it. So yeah, there's not really too much to it. If you are on the Xbox, this one should be Xbox friendly. As long as you do switch out a couple of blocks, I think the only thing you really need to do, I always use these iron blocks, but that just doesn't look that good in the default texture pack which you're using on Xbox 360. And also PS3 now, I believe you guys have got Minecraft, so this one will work on that as well. So if there is any blocks that you need to switch out, I'll be actually telling you guys you know, which ones to switch out when we actually get to it. For some reason I've got a white stripe going down this as well, which I can't remember doing, but oh well. So yeah, let's get started on this tutorial. Okay, so if you are building this one underwater, or you're building it like I am on land and then putting it into water using a tool like MC Edit or World Edit, just show you how far you need to be down. So you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7 layers down. So you're going to need to go down by 7 layers. If this is your water here, what I usually do with my ships is I have a layer of red, a layer of black, and then it goes onto the main hull colour. You guys can do the same. This just kind of looks really nice. Or you can, of course, go up and have 8 layers underneath the water if you want just the black layer showing. It's kind of up to you with this one. But you have got 7 layers, so it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Yeah, so you've got 7 layers underwater. So let's get started on this tutorial. Okay, so I'm going to be building this one on land, the reason being that you guys can see it a lot clearer if I do it on land. If I do it underwater, it gets insanely complicated and you can't clearly see exactly what I'm doing. So again, if you are building this underwater and you want a layer of red and black, then do it 7 blocks under. So this is where you're going to be starting. You're just going to do 3 blocks, 1, 2, and 3. And then what you're going to do is you're going to go 3 wide in total, and you're going to go back, counting this block, 22 blocks, so you've already got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, and 22. This will be 3 wide in total. All I'm going to do is I'm just going to do the outline kind of box for it. I advise that you do the same and then kind of fill it in later, because when you've got an outline of the actual ship, you can just spend a little bit of time filling it in. So now what you're going to do is you're going to go 5 wide. And this one's going to go back by 10, so you've already got 1 there, so you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And again, just to outline for the time being, just like that. And then you're going to go 7 wide, so you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, yep. And this one's going to go back by 5, so you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and again, 9 wide, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and then this one's going to go back by 5 as well, so you get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's box this one off again. And then you got 11 wide, so you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. This one goes back by 8 in total count. This one, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Just like this. And then go out by 1 again. I'm going to stop counting the actual how many goes out by because it does get quite wide. So this one's 11 going back. So you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. And again, just box this one off. Just like that. Go one wide again. And then this one's another 5. So you got 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Go across. And again, you're going to go another yet again, and this one is another 5 as well, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So already you can kind of see that this is going to be a big ship just by doing this kind of slight front part. And then what you're going to do is you're going to go out once more. This is going to be the widest part of the ship. It's also going to be your longest run. So this goes back by 52 in total, so you've already got 1, 2, three, and then go all the way back 52 blocks, and I'll catch you guys when I've done the box for this. Okay, so that's what you should have for your 52 layer. You should have just a really, really big box. So now what we're going to do is we're actually going to come in one block on each side, so you can do the same as we were doing before and just create this clear section. So you're going to be one block in from each side. This is going to be 4, okay, in that box. You got 1, 2, 3, and 4. And again, just create your box going around this one like that. And you're going to go in again. So you can just do this going across if you want to. And this one's just going to be 3, so you've already got 1, 2, and 3. And then box this off again. Just like that. Go in yet again. And this one's going to be a 4, so you got 1, 2, 3, and 4. So you go 1, 2, 3, 4. And again, box this off. Like that. And I've just noticed that I've made this mistake here, so you should actually have this. I'm just going to double check. Like that. There we go. So you should just be in, and then you have this 4, 3, 4. Like that. I had just for some reason done an extra 1. So just to make sure you guys haven't done the same on that. And then if you come in again, just one more block. And this one's going to be a 5, so you got 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And then box this one off again. Just like that. So I almost made the mistake again, so you got this 5 like this. Next one is going to be a 4, so if you come in again, and then 1, 2, 3, 4. 2, 3, 4, join it together, just like that. And again, this is going to be a 7 this time, so you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and like that. Next one, you're going to come in again, and this one's just going to be a 2, so you've only got this 2 showing here, and then right at the end, you've just got 3 just on the back, like that. So this is what you should have if I try and get an aerial view, what we've currently got. There we go. So all you need to do now, just to finish off this layer, what I'm going to be doing now as well, is just come onto all of these ones and just fill in the gaps and make a solid kind of floor for your ship. So do that, and I'll get back to you guys for layer number 2. Okay, and once you've filled in all of that for layer number 1, what you're going to do is you're going to come to the front and come forwards by 2 blocks in total. So you've got 2 here. Connect 1 onto the side. Now what I'm going to do for this tutorial is just do the sides as I do with my other ships, if this is your first ship. So if I say, for example, this one is going to go back by 22, so you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 20, 21, 22, it's actually 23. So what you guys are going to do is you're going to do it on the other side as well. I advise doing this at the same time, but in the tutorial what I'm going to be doing is I'm just going to be showing you how to do it on one side so you guys can, you know, I'll show you how to do it one side and you'll just be able to copy it onto the other. And then the next one, what you're going to do is you're going to come out and you're going to have a 9. So you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. And again, just copy this onto the other side. You can either do it right at the end, which is what I do, or you can do it and, you know, pause the video and then do it on the other side while you're going through it. So then next one is 7. So you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7, like this. Next one is a 3, so you got 1, 2, and 3. Next is a 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And you got another 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Next is a 6, so you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And all you're going to do on these gaps that are going to start appearing is just put in a couple extra blocks. And next one is 5, so you got 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And again, you'll be filling in this bit in a second. I actually advise doing it at the end. And next is a 5 as well, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Next is a 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So you can actually just fill these in from this section here. Just like this. There we go, so that gives you that. It's just easier for me to show you the outside kind of layers that are showing, and then you can just fill them in like that. So then the next one is going to be a 52. So this last letter here was a 52, and it actually goes out just by this one block gap. So if we just bring this one back all the way, it should be exactly in line as the last layer. So you should actually be up to here, and then again, come in and just fill in this part here, and I'll get back to you for the back part. And then what we're going to do after you've done that is we're just going to come inwards this time. So you're on this block now, so you got 1, 2, 3, and 4, which is again in line here, so you can then put in your 4 in the back, or wait until the end. The next one is a 3, so you got 1, 2, and 3. You're then going to come inwards again, and you got a 3, 1, 2, 3, another 3, 1, 2, and 3. So we've got currently 3 3s. There is 4 in total, so we've got another one. So 1, 2, 3, so here we go, so we got 1, 2, 3, and 4 sets of 3. Got 2 sets of 4, so you got 1, 2, 3, and 4. Next one is 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4. And then you got 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And now what you're going to do is if you grab a block of iron and also a block of gold, we just come into this part here, we're going to go towards the back by 12 in total. So you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. Grab your blocks of gold, put two blocks of gold on here, one of them on the bottom, and the other two are going to be diagonals. The Pennsylvania class actually had three propeller type things. I can't remember what you actually call these. I guess they are retro propellers. So you've actually got these kind of three areas. If you did want a four, all you have to do is just do it on each of these diagonals like this. But if you want it more accurate to the actual ship, do it like this. And then if you grab your red wall again, just put one on each of these sides like this for the time being. Just like that. And then if you come around the back, we're just going to go across here by 3, and again by 3. So this is where, when you do it on the other side, you'll have your other propeller will be in this gap here. You go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. Two blocks of gold, one on the bottom. Got your diagonals like this. And then you're going to have these bits which will connect into the back like that. So now what we're going to do is we're just going to put in this back rudder, or at least the basis for it, so let's do this. Okay, and setting up for the back rudder, what you're going to do is if we just use these iron blocks as counting, so we're just going to go to the middle. So if you find yourself your middle here, which should be in line with these, then you're just going to have a 3 block gap, so you got 1, 2, and 3, and then you have 4 pieces of red wool, 1, 2, 3, 4, like that. So you've got these 1, 2, 3, and then it's in line with this part here, so you've actually got this 3 block gap between the end of these and the actual rudder there, and it's just one block off the ground like that. So then copy this side that we've just done here onto the other side, and we will get onto layer number 3. Okay, so for layer number 3, what you're going to do is come to the front, place one block directly on top of the last one, and now what you're going to do is you're going to have a 15, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Next one is going to be a 14, so you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Next is a 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Next is a 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Next is a 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, and another 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Next is a 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, a 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Next is a 5, so you got 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, another 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and one more 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Now the next one is going to be 54 in total, so this time, instead of it being the 52, it's going to be 1 on each side, so you will probably have to fill in a block like this. So if you just drag this one all the way back, directly kind of just basically outlining the last layer. It will be a, there we go, so that one will be a 53, so then there's your 54, just like that. So place a block in behind it, just for, you know, doing it now, and then you're going to have a 3, so you've got 1, 2, and 3. Next one is a 3, 1, 2, 3. Next one's a 3 as well, so 1, 2, and 3. Another 3, 1, 2, 3, and one more 3, so you've got 1, 2, 3. So you should have 5 sets of 3, so you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, just like that. Next, you're going to have a 4, so you get 1, 2, 3, and 4, and another 3, 1, 2, 3. And now what you're going to do is grab your block of iron, just place it on here. This is going to be the other two kind of propellers on the side. They are a slightly different kind of pitch. You can see this one's a little bit higher, so this is one we're doing now. So you're going to go forwards by 9, so you get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Grab your block of gold, and do exactly the same as we did before. So just doing these kind of bits like this, also with your red wall underneath and also on the sides, like that. So that will just give us our kind of basic propeller there. If we then come on to the inside part after we've done that, and just this one here is going to have a 1, then we're going to have a 3, 1, 2, and 3, and then there's just going to be 3 across the back like this. So you have to kind of fill in this gap as well at the back, so you have to 1, 2, 3 like that. So do the same on the other side, and we will get on to the next layer. And just before I forget, if we just add an extra 3 blocks onto the an extra 4 blocks onto the back rudder there, and then if you do the back, and we'll get onto layer number 4. Okay, so we're now onto layer number 4, so what you need to do is come to the front, and you're going to come inwards by one block, because if you see the front of the ship here, it goes out a little bit, and then it comes back in and goes up a little bit. So we've just got this one block here. And then we got a 7, so you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Then you're going to go out and you've got a 17, so you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. Next one is a 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And then you got a 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4. A 3, 1, 2, and 3. A 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4. And then a 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and a 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and then you got another 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, a 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4, and then again you're going to have a 54, so it's going to be just outlining this one here. So it is quite complex. I might just quickly run through exactly what I've been doing on this part. So you've got this 1 inwards, then you have a 7, 17, a 6, 7, 4, 3, 4, then you've got a 5, and then you've got a 6, then a 5, then a 5, then a 4, and then this one here is going to be a 54. So if you just bring this one back, it will just be outlining the last layer. Usually the middle is kind of pretty simple on the ships compared to the rest of it, so if you just outline right to this point here, and then what you're going to do is you're going to have 11 sets of 3. So you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and then 11. So there's quite a lot of 11. There's quite a lot of 3. So you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. Which should just bring you right in line with this back part here. And then just across the back, you just have an extra 3 going across this way like that. And on this back rudder, all we're going to do is we're going to have 5. And it's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So the fifth one is going towards the ship. What we can also do is if we just on this kind of back part here, just go up by about 3 blocks. And on this one, if we just go up by about 2, I think, just on that part there. These will then connect into the kind of bottom of it. This one will go a lot earlier. So we'll probably just kind of drag those up when we need to. So just do the same on the other side, and we'll get on to the next layer. And now for layer number 5, what you need to do is place a block right on this one here and go back by 1. So you've got 2 here. Now you've got now you're going to have a 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And now 11, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 10, so you got, 10, so you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and then you got 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 3, 1, 2, and 3. Another 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4, 4. Then we're going to have is 2 sets of 5, so you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Another 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. 6, 1, 2, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And then what you're going to do is going to have 5 again, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Now what you should be, 3 of them should be overhanging here, so you've got 3 showing here, and this is where you're going to have a 59, so you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and if you just drag this all the way back to the time being, so all you need to do is just bring it right in line with this, because you've got 3 on that side, which brings it up to 57, to make it 59, all you have to do is add an extra 2 blocks onto the back part here. Then what we're going to do is we're going to have a 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Then a 3, 1, 2, 3, another 3, 1, 2, and 3. Then you have a 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4. And then the next one is going to be a 3, so you've got 1, 2, and 3. Another 3, 1, 2, and 3. A 2, 1, 2. And you're then going to have a 3, 1, 2, 3. A 2, 1, 2. And then a 3, 1, 2, 3, another 3, 1, 2, 3. And then if you come in, you're just going to have a 2 just here. So what's going to happen on the back is you also have, on this part here, you have a 2 going across. Just put in the rough kind of framework what you should have on the back. So you can see that that part that we put in here then joins into this side part here. I'm not sure if it goes up higher or not. We'll see in a second. But just at the back, you're just going to join this across here. And just fill in the gaps, and like we did before on the other layers, just fill in these gaps here. And I think that's pretty much it. We just need to put on a little bit extra on the rudder. So for this, what you're going to do is you're going to add 7. So you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7 like this, which creates this kind of curve going across there. So then do the same on the other side, and we'll get on to the next layer. Okay, so for layer number 6, what you need to do is you just need to put 1 on top of this one, so you're going 1 back from this kind of layer here. Then you're going to have 4, 1, 1, 2, 3, and 4. And a 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. And then a 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then we're going to have is a 3, so you've got 1, 2, and 3. 2 sets of 4, so you got, if I can actually place them right, there you go, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Another 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4. 2 sets of 5, so you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Another 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Then a 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And then a 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And then the next one is going to be 56 in total. So what you need to do is just come out here and you're going to have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56. So you should be in line with this one right here. So where we did have the 54s, I believe it was, it should be in line with there, but of course you've got a couple extra on top, so you should be too short from this back part here. You're then going to have a 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4. You have a 3, 1, 2, 3, a 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Then we have 3 sets of 3, 1, 2, 3, and 2, 1, 2, 3, and then a third set of 3 like this. So we've got 3, 3, and then another 3 here. 2 sets of 2 this time, 1, 2, then 1, 2, so we've got 2 sets of 2, a 3, 1, 2, and 3. And then a 2, 1, 2, a 3, 1, 2, 3, and then we're going to have a 3 as well here, going this way, 2, 3, like this. So it should just be right onto the side of this part. This one here will be completely connected in now. So if we just do this part here at the back, so I'll just create a little bit of the back part, which of course you guys will finish up in a second. So if we've got this here, all you're going to do with the rudder is lay right on top, and you're going to bring this one right between until you get to here. So you actually bring this here and it actually connects in like that, so you actually get this kind of curve effect going across here like this, and then just on these two side parts just add an extra block just like that. And the only other thing we need to do is just fill in a couple of these holes here, or just one hole, so do the same on the other side, and we'll get onto the next layer. Okay, and now we're onto layer number 7, so what we need to do is come in by one block right here, so you've got this kind of step back, and we will start going back out again after we've got this really long straight part here. Then we have a 3, and then a 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9, and then a 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Three sets of 5, so you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So you've got three sets of 5, then you've got 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4. You got 3, 1, I forgot how much you place these right, 1, 2, and 3, which will just cover up that little bit there. And then what you're going to do is you're going to have a 5, so you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, a 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4, 2 sets of 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, another 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and then you have a 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Now the next one what you're going to do is you're going to have a 63, so if our last one here was 56, we're going to have 5 on this side, so you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then you're just going to bring this straight on top. Because we've got 5 extra on this one, and this run is a total of 56, that means that we're up to 61, so we just need to add 2 blocks just for this one to make it a 63 in total. And the next is a 6, so you get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Next is a 3, 1, 2, and 3. You got 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, another 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4. And then you've got a 2, so you've got 2 here. 3, 1, 2, 3. Then 2 sets of 2, 1, and then you've got another 2, just like that. Then you have a 3, so you've got 1, 2, and 3. 2, 3, and then another 3, 1, 2, and 3. So when you've got the other 3 on this side here, so I'll just continue, just do a little bit of the back here at this. What you're going to do with the rudder is you're just going to have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then there's going to be an extra block right on the end, kind of going outwards. As you can see, we start to also create a, well, not really a proper curve here, but it just starts to move a little bit this way, like that. So do the same on the other side, and we will get onto the next layer. Okay, now for layer number 8, which is the last layer of red. So we're kind of through most of this really difficult, pretty difficult kind of laying on top part. Most of this should be pretty standard, really, the rest of it, or at least pretty a bit easier than this, and at least it looks a lot better than just a big red kind of bottom of a ship. So what we're going to do first is we're going to have one on top of this one here, and this will be a 2 in total, so you're going to go back by one in like that. Next is a 3, so you got 1, 2, and 3, so it's just in a little bit here like that. You've then got an 8, so you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Next is a 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Next you've got is a 3, so you've got 1, 2, 3, then you've got a 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Then you got a 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4, and a 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And then you got a 4, 2, 3, 4, and a 3, 1, 2, and 3. So most of this is actually just outlining the last layer. We've then got a 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4, just like that. Then a 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Another 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. A 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And we'll just leave it there for the time being, just because we need to put in a block right there. So then we'll go on to the longest layer here. And this one is going to be 68 blocks in total. So if our last one here was 63, we've actually got 4 extra. So we've got 1, 2, three, four, and then we're just going to bring all of these ones right on top of this. And if we bring it directly on top, that gives us a 67 in total, because we've got four at the front. And this last layer here is 63, so what we need to do is just add one block towards the back part of this, just like that. Next one we've got is an 8, so we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Then we've got a 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. We've then got a 3, so we've got 1, 2, and 3. Then we've got a 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Then we've got a 3, so we've got 1, 2, 3, and then a 2, and then a 3. 2, 3, add a 2, just there, so you got, on that bit there, we got 3, 2, 3, and 2, then we got again another 3, 2, 3, and another 2, so we got quite a lot of this 3, 2 thing, and then we got a 3, 2, and 3, and then we got a 4, so you got 1, 2, 3, and 4, a 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, then right at the end we got a 3, 1, 2, and 3. So you should have on the other side as well, 6 here when you do the other side. And then all you need to do is just fill in these gaps as we've been doing on a couple of layers. I think it's quite just a couple of these. But after you've done it on the other side, we are done with the red wall. So we're on to the kind of black layer, and then we'll get onto the greys and all that kind of stuff. So we're pretty much we're getting quite far with the kind of basic part of the ship, so let's do this. Okay, now on to layer number 9, which is the black layer, which we've got just here. So what we're going to do is place one block on this one here, and it's going to be 2 in total. So you go back just by 1, then you have a 3, so you got 1, 2, and 3. And then you got 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Next one is going to be a 4, so you got 1, 2, 3, and 4. And next one is going to be a 3, so you got 1, 2, 3, another 3, 1, 2, and 3. Now you got 5 sets of 4, so you got 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. So there should be 5 sets of 4 in total. So you got 1, 2, 3, 4, so there's the first one. 1, 2, 3, 4, add 5. And then we got 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7 now. So you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Another 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Then this one is going to go directly on top of this last layer. The only difference is that it's going to be just, it's got this extra block right on the front, but on the back part, it's actually directly on top. So I'll show you what I mean as I pull this one back here. So if we pull this one all the way back to, all the way back, right to on top of there. And I just noticed right at the front, there's a couple of these little gaps that we need to fill in as well. Just in case you forget. If you do find these throughout the build, it just means that they've actually got to do what I've just done there and just adding a couple ones. So let's get back to, get to the back part. And now I've got a 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. And a 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, another 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then we got 3 sets of 3. So you got 1, 2, 3, 2, 2, 3, 3. And then we got 1, 2, 3, 4. And 5, and then again, come into the back part and just fill these in. Oh, like that. So you should have 5 sets of 3. I'm just going to check these now. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And then we got a 2, and then a 3, 1, 2, 3. Now we've got a 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 3, a 2, and then just a 1, which should be directly on top of that one. All you have to do is just make sure that you fill up these gaps kind of behind, and do that on the other side, and then you can throw away your black wall because we'll only need it later for the guns. And we'll get on to the next section, which I'll go through with you guys as well. Okay, so before we start onto the light grey kind of colour, what I use, if you're using Sphax and you have connected textures, I recommend using iron blocks, because when you actually have them with connected textures, it looks kind of like this, which kind of looks like armor, and also when you cut out it gets these cool kind of girder marks like that. If you guys are on the Xbox or PS3 versions, or if you're just using another texture pack as well, you can kind of, a kind of common thing to use for shipped kind of armor is light gray wool or stone as well. That's also quite common if you're on survival. If you're building this on survival, then you're pretty nuts, but using stone will be cheaper. Another alternative you have is actually using clay blocks these days, because that also looks pretty good, and it's of course fireproof, whereas the light grey wool isn't fireproof. So kind of choose what you're going to be using. If you're on the Xbox or PS3, I recommend using light grey wool. I actually prefer the look of it and those kind of things, and rather than the actual stone, but it's really up to you. So of course I'm going to be using the iron blocks because that's what works in my texture pack. So let's get started on layer number 10. Okay, for layer number 10 what you need to do is you're going to have two on top of this. Then we're going to do is you're going to have a 3, so you get 1, 2, and a 3. Another 3, 1, 2, and 3. Then a 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Two sets of 3, so you get 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, and 3. And then a 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Then a 3, 1, 2, and 3. And then a 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Another 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Then what you're going to do is you're going to have a 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and a 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And a 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and an 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And then this longest run is going to be straight on top of the last layer. So all you need to do is just lay the kind of blocks directly on top, like this. And bring it all the way back. There we go, so you've got that directly on top of the last layer. And then you're going to have an 11, so you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. Next one is a 5, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, 2, 1, 2, and a 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And next one's going to be 3, so you got 1, 2, and 3. And it's going to be 5 sets of 3 in total, so you got 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, just like that. Then you got 2, a 3, 2, and then just a 1 to finish it off. And there should be, if we have a look here, there we go. So there's a couple of them that you need to kind of fill in the gaps, but I believe it's only on the back that you need to do that. So do the same on the other side, and we'll get to the next layer. So actually on this one, because of the way the ship is, I think there's 8 layers going up straight to the front, and there's 5 at the back, so it should start to get easier. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we've got 4 more, and then the back kind of, it'll be done, and that'll just be the next one. Okay, so for layer number 11, what you're going to do is lay these two straight on top of the last layer, and then what you're going to do is you're going to have a 2, then a 3, 1, 2, and a 3, and then a 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 2 sets of 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, and 3. Then a 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. And a 3, 1, 2, 3. And then a 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Another 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4. And then a 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And then 11, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. And it should cut in 2 blocks behind this one. There's this kind of weird shape that I was trying to get on this ship. So it should just be 2 on this one. This longest run is just going to go, leaving these 2 exposed here, go straight on top, and at the back it's actually exactly the same. So it'll be straight on top. So if we just take these out here, bring this all the way back. So that one's directly on top, just like that. Then you got a 12, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. A 6, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Then what you're going to do is you're going to have a 2. So you got 1, 2. And then a 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And then you got 3, 1, 2, and 3. A 2, 1, 2. Then a 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4. 3, 1, 2, and 3. And 4 sets of 2, so you got 1, 2, 3, and 4. Then right on the end, just a 1, just like that. So the back is pretty much just straight up here, as you can see, but the rest of it kind of has a bit more shape to it. So do the same on the other side, and we will get on to the next layer. Okay, now we're on to layer number 12. You need to go 2 on the front here, straight on top of the last layer. And then we've got another 2. A 1, now we've got 5, so you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. 2 sets of 3, so you've got 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, and 3. 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and a 3, 1, 2, 3, a 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, a 3, 1, 2, 3, and then a 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And the next is 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 14, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and 14, which should go 13 back of this long layer. Not 13 back of this long layer, 3 back of this long layer. You just place one right on the back here. Drag this right on top of the last layer, like this. And I'll just be bringing it back all of the way. Right to on top of the last layer, just like that. Then you've got a 12. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Then a 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and a 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Then you got a 2, a 3, 1, 2, and 3. Now you got a 7, so you got to come onto the inside here, and you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So these bits here are the kind of, as you can see them on here, these kind of gun parts, like that. And then what you're going to do is you're going to have a 1, and a 1, and then a 7, so you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6, and 7, and then a 2, 1, 2, a 1, a 2, a 1, and a 2 right on the back, like that. So we've got two of these kind of bits at the back here where it kind of cuts back into the deck, not into the deck, into the ship. I'll show you when we kind of finish the top part, if you do want to put in these kind of secondary guns. They were taken off when the Arizona was actually sunk. They weren't actually on the ship. There was a couple of modifications. This is the kind of one before it was sunk, just before, so it was kind of the most updated version of it before it was gone. So then just do this on the other side and we'll get on to the next layer. Okay, and for layer number 13, what you need to do is have one right on the front here. Now we're going to have a 2, and a 2, and a 3, 1, 2, and 3, and a 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, a 2, just on top of this one here, then a 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, and a 3, 1, 2, 3, and then we've got a 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, a 3, 1, 2, 3, so those ones are straight on top, a 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8, just be one back of this layer here, and 14, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and 14, which pushes this one back just by one block, and again, this will just pretty much be on top, so just bring this one all the way back, without trying to put too many blocks on the sides, so just bring this one back like normal, and it'll just go straight on top, just like we've been doing before. Next one is a 12, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12, which goes straight on top. Then we've got a 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, they're 2, and they're 3, so these ones are mostly on top now. They're 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7, a 1, 1, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7, 2, 1, 2, 1, and 2. So pretty much most of the back part is actually just layered directly on top of the last. Actually, I think all of it is. So do the same on the other side, and we'll get on to the next layer. Okay, so we're on layer number 14. So what you need to do is go to the front, place one right on top of this one here. Then you've got a 1 this time, and now you've got a 2, and another 2, and now a 5, 4, and 5, and a 2. Now you have an 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And you've got a 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4. And a 1, and a 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Like that. Then a 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And then a 15, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. And 15, which should just be one back of this one. This long run again is just in one back. And if you just drag this one all the way on top, I can actually place the blocks correctly, like this. drag this one all the way back, and it'll just go straight on top. Then you can have a 12, so you get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. And a 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4, and 5, like that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 is the next one. You got a 2, a 3, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. 1, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. 2, 1, 2, 1, and 2. So that layer as well, right at the back, all the way from this kind of bit, is actually just straight on top, so it's really, really easy. Okay, so now what you need to do is just copy this onto the other side, and then we can start putting in this back deck. What we'll do first is we'll actually, after we've put in this kind of back deck, the rough kind of place where it needs to go, is we'll just finish off the entire front part so that we've got most of the ship and we can just build on top of it. So just copy that onto the other side and we'll get onto it. Okay, and then once you've done that on both sides, what we're going to do is we're going to fill in the floor. So if you grab oak wood planks or any other type of planks that you want, I've used oak wood on mine. So what you do is, when you've got this long run here, if you just go count back 22, so you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22. You just bring this all the way across. This is kind of like your minimum amount that you need to fill in for this ship itself. And all you need to do is just go around the entire ship and fill this kind of back section here in with wood. You could do it on the other one. If I just fly over to mine over here, if you do continue it on, that'll give you the floor underneath, but because of the actual kind of way the ship is, you only get a space of 2. So if you wanted this inside area here to be you know, have a height of 3, instead you'd have to then drop down another layer, possibly. It's really up to you what you want to do with this one. But that is your kind of minimum that you can actually put in off the floor just for this back part here. So fill this all in and I'll get back to you for the next bit. Okay, and then once you've filled in this back section, what we're going to do is, if you just grab your hull colour, and we're just going to go around and kind of join these bits up on the inside. You'll see why in a second. So just go around and do this. It's just on this kind of back part that we're doing this. Not on the entire ship, so just where you've got the kind of wood going up to it. Around all of this section like this. Just switching out a couple of these blocks. And then once you've kind of joined up all of those, grab iron bars or fence. I prefer iron bars on mine, but it depends on your texture pack. And what we're going to do is we're just going to go on the outside part of this and create a railing if I can actually place it. And what I do on mine is I wrap mine around, which is why we put that extra block in, just so that we can actually do that. So we can just go around the entire ship, well, not the entire ship, the entire back section of the ship, and put these in. So go around that, just doing the back section. As you can see, it kind of joins into the hole there later on. So do that, and then we'll get on to the next part. Okay, and now we're going to go back to the front, and we're just going to finish off doing this main kind of part of the ship so we can put in the top deck as well. So come to the front and place one block straight on top, and you're going to just add one to each side. So you've got 3 going across the front part, just like this. And now what you're going to do is you're going to have a 2, and then another 2, then a 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Next one is going to be a 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So you should have these 3 showing. Those are going to be those front gun parts there, just like that. We're going to have a 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. 2 sets of 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. And you have a 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. There's your other one right there. A 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And a 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. A 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9, which will just be one back from the last one. And now what you're going to do is you're going to have a 56 from here. So you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 55, 56. So this one should be 2 blocks kind of over where we put in this ground here. So it should just be there like that. So then do the same on the other side, and we'll go to the next bit. I think what we're going to do is this back part here, we'll actually just basically do the outline of the ship and then put in this kind of deck here, because it does go up a little bit more. We'll finish that off just before we fill in the deck. So do the same for kind of on this side, and we'll go to the next layer. Okay, and for layer number 16, come to the front and come forwards just by one block here. Then you're going to have a 1, 1, and then the next is going to be 2, so you've got 1, 2, another 2, 1, 2, then you have a 10, so you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Should just go straight on top of that one where we've got this kind of gap here. Then you've got 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then you've got a 3, 1, 2, 3, another 3, 1, 2, and 3. Then a 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And a 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And a 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. And this one is just going to go straight on top, the last layer, and it's going to be one short right at the back, so you can just drag this one all of the way, back, and you're just going to be one short like this. So we're actually going to be creating a step pattern, as you can see here, going all the way up. So do the same on the other side, and we'll get onto the last layer of this kind of raised hole bit, and then the rest of it will basically just fill in the back, put in the deck, and then finish off the back section, finish off the front section, then move on to this midsection here. Okay, now for layer number 17, what you're going to do is place one block right on the front part here and just add one to each side, so you're going three wide, just like that. And then what we're going to do is we're going to have a 1, and then another 1, so you've got 1, 1, and then a 2, 1, 2, and then you're going to have a 12, so you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. Should be straight on top of that one there. Then you got a 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. A 3, 1, 2, 3, another 3, 1, 2, 3. A 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and a 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. 5, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and a 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. And then this one is going to be straight on top and one short, so this layer is pretty easy. So we just drag this one all the way back. Just to there, like that. So do the same on the other side, and what we're going to do is there's this little extension that just comes out. We're going to put that in, and then we're going to just go around the back part, and then we can move on to the next kind of the kind of proper parts of the ship. Now we're pretty much done with setting up the bases for it, so let's do this. Okay, and then once you've done that on both sides, what you need to do is we need to count back from here 13 of these. What I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be using slabs on top so I can show you exactly what I mean. So I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. And if you just add onto the side here, we're going to go 15 in total. So you get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. And I can just cut around or just cut out this middle part. I'll get rid of these kind of guides as well. So that'll give you this kind of extension part here, which goes out on the side. So copy this onto the other side as well, and we'll do this little back bit. Okay, and then the next thing we need to do is, where we've got this wall here, where it goes kind of steps up, counting this block, we're going to go 8 in total. So we've already got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Make this a total of 3 high. And you'll be doing it on the same on the other side as well, as it'll join up into the middle in a second. And now what we're going to do is we're going to have a 3, so we're just going to go here and go 1, 2, 3. So we've got 3 of them kind of facing this way, looking that way. And then what we're going to do is we're going to have 2 going this way. So again, you can build this up to a total height of 3 for the time being. It does go higher, but it's just easier to do it this way. So we've got 8 this way, then we've got 3 this way. 2 going across this way, and then we've got 4 going towards the back. So you've got 1, 2, 3, and 4. Again, just join this up like this. And if we do the same on the other side as well, so we've already got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Make it 3 high. And then you've got 3 this way, 1, 2, 3. Again, make it 3 high. Then 2. And then you've got 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Just like this, and then just join these two together. Like that, and also put one just right on the middle part. Just like that. So now the next thing that you need to do is grab your oak wood planks. It's going to be easier for me to show you exactly what to do. So most of the front anyway is oak wood planks. I advise just doing the entire floor with the planks anyway, so that you've got the kind of inside floor, which you can always cut out earlier, kind of later on, because this raised bit that we've got here, this kind of raised section here, we're currently on this level. That bit we'll be doing kind of last. as we'll put in all of the guns and everything like that first. So all you need to do is grab your whatever planks you've used at the back, the same ones, grab those and just fill in the deck level here. So fill in this entire section, it's quite a big section. So it will probably take you quite a while, it's going to take me a while to do it as well. So after you've done that, I will get back to you guys for doing this back section here, because we might as well finish it off.
Okay,
so once you've filled in the entire deck, you should have this kind of nice platform for us to start building on. What we're going to do is we're just going to come to the back part for the time being and just put in the flag. So just grab another brick fence and go up by 5, so you've got 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, just like this. Then grab your red wool and just go on the bottom part right here, then white, then blue. And then what you're going to do is we're going to actually come forwards like this. So you've got a diagonal here, same level though, and the same again, just for your actual kind of stripes like this. So this is going to be your blue part. Grab your buttons. These are the closest we can get for stars, so just put these just on the front and also on the back. And then what we're going to do is we're going to go down by one level. So it's going to be red, white, and red like this. And then we're going to go back at the same level here. So we've got red, white, and red. And then same next to this one, but down one level, we're going to do the red, white, and red again. So this is quite a complex flag, unfortunately. And then the last one, what it's going to be is just one backwards like this. So that's how you make the kind of flag to make it look like it's going backwards. So just to give you a kind of top view, so you've got this one and two, then it goes back to that level, and then goes back by one. And as far as this way it's concerned, it's basically just going down by two. So you've got two at this height, two this height, two this height like that. So that finishes off the back part. So you've got at least got the flag. We are now going to work our way back pretty much. So we're going to build this crane here. What I'll do is I've got a separate tutorial for the actual plane, so I'll tell you where to kind of put them in. I haven't actually released that tutorial yet, but it'll be the Monday after this tutorial comes out. You'll get the plane tutorial. I'll make sure that that goes up, and you'll get all of these. You'll get this thing, but I'll show you where I've put mine, you know, according to this block here or something like that. But the guns will be fine. Of course, we've got another plane up there. And we'll just finish off this kind of back section, all the stuff that's on this back section, so we can just kind of say that that's done, then onto the front. So let's do this. Okay, so for the back crane, the first thing you need to do is we're just going to create a cross pattern just here. So you've got these kind of three pieces of your wood showing there. Then just add two to the middle and come forwards. And we're also going to have another two and come forwards. And this one's going to go up by three in total. Just add one to the front, add one to the back of this one. And then come backwards this way, and we're going to have three like this. And then coming forwards, we've got two, making our way up like that. That gives us the kind of frame for the actual crane. So now we'll put in the nether brick fence. Okay, so for the nether brick fence, just lay it on the top of these parts here, just going all the way back. And then you can come down a couple, maybe one, two, three. And if you want to, you can either just have it like this, or you can actually go around and create kind of like a claw type thing for that. And then what we're going to do is if we come to the base of it, and if we just put them around the edges, the corners of these, and also on these parts here, so that's making its way up, just like that. And then go up the back of this part as well, so connect into here, and also extend this one right there. And then this one here is going to go 1, 2, and 3, and it should just connect in right into the back part like that. And that finishes off the crane, so it's pretty simple. It's not too complex, so hopefully you guys have got that one all right. So now what we'll do is we'll set up for this kind of the launcher for the actual plane here. Okay, now for the launcher for the plane, if you just find your crane here and you're just going to count back 8, so I'm just going to use those cobblestone slabs for this. So you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Then we're going to do is this is just going to be a cross pattern right on the back of this one like this. So you can just take away these slabs, they were just to count. So this is where your main platform is going to be. Just add one to the middle here. Grab your slabs and just put them around each of the outside parts like this. Then grab your block of iron again, and towards this kind of back part here, we're going to add 5. So you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And you're going to have an upside down stone stair and 2 cobblestone slabs like that. And then towards the front of the battleship, what you can do is add 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and stair, and then two slabs, exactly the same. Grab your rail, I just laid this straight on top, just like that, and that's pretty much it for it. I'll just show you where you're actually going to be putting on the plane. So again, this will be the Monday after, so this one is the Val OS2U Kingfisher, so that's the one you need to put on. So where I've put this one is directly above this kind of cross. That's where the first block of stone brick stairs that I've actually used in there. Not stone brick stairs, stone brick. So you got 1, 2, 3, and 4. So if I just show you exactly what I mean on this part here, I know myself. That's why you actually have the 4, it'll be here. So you got 1, 2, 3, and 4. There's that kind of main part. That's why you'll be putting it on this launching rail like that. So now what we'll do is we'll get onto one of the guns. Okay, and now what you're going to do is we're going to set up for this first lower gun, this one right here. So I'm just going to use cobblestone slabs just to count back from this kind of thing here we've got here. So I'm going to count back 14, so I'm going to use these here. So you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and 14. Then grab your block of iron, just going to place one, place two on each side. So you got this kind of 5 here, I'm just going to get rid of these quickly. So that's, so you got 5, then you have 1, you got 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 5, and a 1. So you've just got this 5-1 circle, which is pretty basic. And then if you grab your cobblestone slabs, what we're going to do is we're actually going to go around the side of these, just in these corners here with cobblestone slabs. Now you can also use things like stone brick slabs as well, it's really up to you what you want to use for this. Just go around like this. I create the base and grab your stone stairs, and we're just going to wrap these around the inside. I'll actually wrap them around these parts. This is the kind of, this kind of creates a slight groove with the actual turret and makes it look like it could actually turn by itself quite easily. And place them correctly. There we go. So just keep on turning these around until you go all the way around, just like this. And then we'll just have to change this one here to get it to wrap around like that. So that gives us the kind of base part of it. Now what we're going to do is I'm just going to build the base part for this one here, because it is pretty much exactly the same. Of course, this one does have the aircraft on it as well. But if, what you're going to do is you're going to have a 3-block gap. 1, 2, 3. And this is where your first set of cobblestone slabs will be. So you have got this 3 kind of block gap between those slabs. Then you're going to have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 1. So that's going to be over circle. So again, you can go around this with your cobblestone slabs. And because this one is up higher, what you're going to do is you're going to extend this warp to 4. So you've got 1, 2, 3, and 4. So just go around the entire kind of this one and just build up to a height of 4. Like this, and keep going around without trying to build the inside part. There we go. Like that, and then again, the same kind of thing that you did here. Just grab your stairs and wrap these around again. So I'll get back to you after you've wrapped your stairs around this part here. Okay, and then once you've done that for both of those, what you're going to do is if we come to this first one here, and just directly on top of these ones, just put 5. Going straight on top, so you can see the kind of groove that I was talking about to make it look like it's actually got a bit more depth with it. And here you're going to have 5, 1, and you have 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Now you're going to have 1, and a 1, and a 3, 1, 2, and 3. If you do the same on the other side as well, so you've got a 1, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and then 1, and 1, like that. So that'll give you this kind of basic shape. If we do the same on this one as well, so it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, we got 1, 1, and then a 3 at the back, 1, 2, 3. So then just continue this on around, so this, with this one add an extra 5 to the front, so just extend this front part, And then with both of these, I'll just show you how to do it on one of them, but where you've got these kind of gaps of light, all you're going to do is just add an extra block on the inside. And of course this one, you'll have to kind of pull it all the way back. But if you just do this for the time being. So do that on the other one as well, and we'll do the next layer for this gun. Okay, and we're going to build the bottom one first, and then we'll build the next one after that. So what you need to do is, if you count back three of these, so you've got one, two, and three, and then just come back here, so you've got a three block gap here, one, two, three. Then you've got this one here, and this one will go across by five, so you've got one, two, three, four, and five. This bottom bit down here, what you can do is actually just add in a couple extra blocks. And then what you're going to do is, if we come to this side, we're then going to go back by five, so you've got one, two, three, four, and five, which should just be one, or a couple of blocks, two blocks on this side, two blocks on this side. Now we're going to have a three, so you've got one, two, three, which will go directly on top, and then another three, one, two, three. So the same on the other side, so you've got this five, one, two, three, four, five, and three here, just like that. And then if we double up this wall here, the only one that doesn't get doubled up is this one that sticks outside. This just kind of stands across the back like this, not on that side there, just like that. And if we just fill in the roof as well, like that. So this is what you should have for the time being. It doesn't look like much at the minute, but it's only this five that's actually sticking out. So if we go back to here, so we'll go one, two, and then three. This is where we're going to place our blocks for the five. One, two, three, four, five. Fill in this floor part here. And on the side we're going to have five, one, two, three, four, five, and three, one, two, three, which will go on top, and three at the back. So we've got this here. And then the only bit we're actually doubling up is just going across this kind of back section like this. And then fill in the roof. Just like that. So that gives us these kind of really basic kind of turrets. And then if you grab your stone slabs, just on this side part here, we're just going to have one, then five, and then a one like that. That's the same on the other side as well. Just like that. And of course the same on the top one here. So I've already made a mistake here and gone across the five, so you got that there. If you grab some light grey wool, or if you've made your ship out of light grey wool, some sort of other material. And just on this part here, we're just going to add two blocks of this other colour, and then just put buttons around the side of it. Same on the other side. So just grab this, put some buttons on it. And it's the same on the other one as well, so it's just here. Like this, add another two. And if we just get our buttons. Like that. So now we'll just build the actual guns themselves. Okay, and if we build the actual barrels themselves, if we just come to the front part here and just add a piece of black wool, which is what I use for this, and then go 12. So you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And then in the middle as well, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 12 there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So it should have three barrels like this. And still it's not looking quite right, and that's because what we need to do is put in a slab just on these two side parts here. Then we're going to have a full block of iron just in behind here. A slab on these two, and I use never brick slab because it's the darkest slab, just to put it on those bits there, which will just finish off the cannon like that, so you can see that it looks a lot better now. So if we just get this one as well, go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And of course in the middle, like this, and to the other one as well. That, and then put in the blocks in these parts and the slabs as well. And after we've done that, we've got the two back cannons. So now what we're going to do is I'm just going to go over how to actually put on this extension part onto the top of this higher one right here. Okay, and then for the other kind of catapult system, what you need to do is if you come to the back part here, and where it's not actually dead in center, it's actually slightly off center, and it's to the left hand side on the ship, that's the back there. So what you're going to do is just come over and come on the back by two blocks like this, and it's going to be 15 in total. So you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. And on the front, you're going to have a stone slab stair. Not stone slabs there. A stone stair like that. And then you've got two slabs, just like we did on the back part here. And the same on the back as well. So you've got the upside down stone stair, and then you have two slabs. And then just put down your rail like this. Like that. And then there's a slight walkway on the side, so what you need to do is just add three blocks here, one, two, and three. So these are using slabs just to create a floor, and another three here. And that goes this way by four, so you got one, two, three, and four. So you can just fill in these. There's just three more slabs here. Grab your iron bars and just wrap these around this little section here. So it's got this kind of small area you can actually walk around on there. And that kind of finishes up the back part, so I'll show you again where the plane will actually go. So let's have a look at this. So if we go towards the back part, so if you just have got these two here, and then you've got the four on the back bit here. So if I just count back those, I'll show you exactly where on this. So you have these two here, and then the four main blocks are actually going to be here. So you've got one, two, three, and four. That's where your two kind of blocks are showing, right on the back. And then the rest of it should kind of make sense when you go through that tutorial, and you can just add those to the top like that. So now I've just got a couple of these little details to do, and we will probably move into the front and move into the front guns. Probably do the chain system, as it'll probably be pretty easy. And then we can keep on moving upwards, so let's do this. Okay, and now for some of these kind of secondary gun parts here. So where we've got this, just go around here, we'll actually just take off this block here and just have it go into here. And just count back three of these. So you've got one, two, and three. You're going to go back one block towards the center and just put down three pieces of your hull colour. Have two on the side like this. Grab your stone brick stair and just put them in these parts like this. Stone brick stairs. Sorry, not stone brick stairs. Stone brick. Completely stone brick block there. Then just have your stairs here. They got upside down ones as well. So this is taken straight from my other Battleship tutorial. And then just add two stone slabs to the front like this. So that's all it is for those kind of small guns. Same on the other side, just make sure to take off this one here. Count three, one, two, three. And go back, one, two, three, and then have two on the sides like this. Stone brick block. Stone brick stairs. Upside down on that one. Get rid of these guides. And then just add two stone slabs right to the front like that. That'll give you two of your gun emplacements. See, that's all of the gun placements on the back. So we've just got a couple of this kind of bits of junk in a way just to put on this on the back of the ship now. Okay, so on this one here, what we're going to do is we're just going to go diagonal. We're just going to have a couple of blocks like this, and just put your stone slabs on like that. So it's pretty easy. So it's just kind of an extra bit. So where we've got this here, just go diagonal by two, and put a couple extra blocks. It's just on that back one there. And then on this one, what we're going to do is, if we leave a two-block gap, just put down two blocks and put stone slabs on top. I'm not sure what these are. They're just kind of like extra details you can add to a ship to make it look a little bit better. So there we go. So we've got a couple there. And we'll also put one on this back part here. So someone will leave a three-block gap. So you've got one, two, three, and then you're going to have two here. Like that. So leave one on the back and two on the front here. And do the same on the other side. One, two, three, and then two, and you got your two stone slabs just like that. Okay, and another little detail we can put in is if we just get kind of go leave a one block gap from this part, and if we just go one block past the next one as well, so we've got one block kind of gap here and a one block gap between this and there. So then we're going to go up by two with our coal colour, then two cobblestone wool. If you don't have cobblestone wool, use your kind of alternative, which will be never brick fence or fence. And I just put a slab on top, and it's the same on the other side, so this will be in line with this one, and it's just going to be one past. So then we've got one block gap there as well, so you've got by two, got by two. And throw a stone slab on, just like that. Okay, and then we've got a couple of boats right on the back of this. So what we're going to do is, where we've got this kind of back section here, we find this part in line with this, and we're going to leave a two-block gap from the edge and place down a stone brick stair, leave a three-block gap, and then put down another stair. Go to the other side, just leave a one-block gap and do the same. And of course on this side it's going to be the same as well, so if we just go around this way, like this, place down these as your kind of feet, And I actually use quartz slabs for these. If you are on the Xbox or on the PS3 version, I don't think you have quartz yet, but you can use any type of wood slab, or you can use any other type of the other slabs, so you've got tons and tons of choice. Sandstone might work as well pretty nicely, sandstone stairs and things like that. So it's really up to you, you've got quite a few options to use. So first thing you need to do is actually, I'm going to grab a block just to build up here, and have an upside down quartz stair here, and just add one to the back. I can do the same on the other side as well, just to add the back. And this is going to be 6 in total, so you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. You could, if you want to, go 7. But I've just done 6 for this one, so you can easily walk around. And then right on the front, just bring one going forwards. And if we just join up around the side. This one's the same, so I'll just leave this for you to guys to copy over. Just grab your quartz slab and just put these straight on top, like this. And also on the front, and then put in your birchwood slab, just put these in the bottom of the actual ship, and then every other one, what you can do is you can put in a kind of seated area. So on this back part, you could, if you wanted to, just join it across the back, or just put in a full slab. I would probably recommend putting in this full slab, I think that looks better. But that gets you these kind of smaller seats that you can actually kind of sit in these grooves. So copy that onto the other one, and that actually finishes up the back detail for all of this kind of back section. So we'll get on to doing the front detail and then the main big middle part. So you're doing really well. Okay, so before we move on to the front kind of anchor system and all of that, what I want you to do is grab your iron bars, and as you can see on this, it doesn't go all the way around the back part, so if you just do it up to here, just grab your iron bars and kind of connect these around. Just keep on making these go around. I'm trying to place too many of them. And when you actually get to, we get there eventually, these parts, just like we did on the back, just take out this and switch it around. So it might be worth going around now and just switching these out. And then go around the entire kind of bit of the ship, just leaving off the back part because it does get raised up. Just do that with iron bars and we'll get onto this system here. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're going to put in a couple of the anchors, and we'll also do the chain system, and we'll just do the anchors first. So where we've got this kind of longer strip that goes across here, if we just find this part underneath the two, just put in iron bars and bring this one out here, and then go down by 4. So this one's 1, so you're 1, 2, 3, and 4, and then just add one to each side, just like this. And then also, there's one here as well, so it's just on this kind of strip where you've got 3 of them here. So again, put that in and go 1, 2, 3, and 4, 4, if you place that one, and just add one to each side, just like that. So that's where you put in the anchors. They'll be the same on the other side as well, so you just go here again, it's just in these spots here, and then 1, 2, 3, and 4, 4, add one to each side, and the same in this part as well, 1, 2, 3, and 4. And add them to each side like that. So now we'll do the chain system. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is just add this fence up here. So you just go 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, just like that. And then with grey wall, what we're going to do is just either side of this. So you've got one block gap here, which is going to cut out, and this will go back in total by 18. So you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. And if we just fill this in with grey wool, just like this, and the same way, also 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, and then again, fill that up with your grey wool. And what we're going to do is we're going to move outwards, and this is just going to go 7, so you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, so it's just like that, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and then behind this, we're going to have a 3x3 box, so we're just going to add an extra 3x3 box onto it. Like this, so you've got 3x3. Just like that. And then grab your cobblestone wall or no brick fence, it depends if you've got it or not, and then put a stone slab on top. And then just in each of these corners, put in a stone slab like this. And what we'll be doing is if we grab anvils, which I believe, I think that one decoration, there we go. So with your anvils, these will be going all the way mostly down, but if you just do this 7 for the time being, put them on like this. Now you can use either anvils, or another thing you can use is cobblestone slab as well. So if I just take out this side, for example. So that's what it'll look like with anvils, and then you can also have your cobblestone slab instead for your chains. It's really up to you. I prefer the anvils, I think they look a little bit better. You can have those there, and then just basically wrap them around this, like that. So, just go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, right-click on them. This, and just have them wrapping around. What we'll do is there's actually 4 of them in total, so I'll just find out what the other ones, where the other ones are. Okay, so if you just count back off this first, we just go 1, 2, 3, and 4, and then the next 2 you're going to cut out. So you've got 4 here, 1, 2, 3, 4, just these wood pieces showing, cut out these 2. And what we're going to do is we're just going to create a couple of steps. So if you just grab your, you can grab your oak wood planks, or you can use your grey wool. We're just going to basically make a couple of steps like this. And I'm just going to cut through this deck here to build this, and I'll show you what I mean. So I'll be bringing these kind of here, and then I'll be going down. It's the deck. You can either have this one go sideways, or you can just leave it. I usually just leave it. The same on the other side as well, so I'll just go into here. I'll just make a couple of steps. So this is coming to this point here. You could, if you wanted to, have it going all the way like this and going around. If you want to put in that detail, put them that way, yeah. So, like that. So if I just have a look at it, if I can get through the roof, I can show you guys what I'm about. So got this here, and those ones go down there. That'll be for the first one, and then all you need to do is just bring these back, the anvils here, right to the back of this part, and that gives you the first 2 chains. We'll do the other ones. Okay, and for the next chain system, what we're going to do is we're going to go, you've got 1 block gap here, and also go to the side and just cut out another 2 to build some steps. So get a step here, right, step here, and I'm just going to cut into this deck here. And do the same on the other side as well, quickly. So, 1 block back, and I cut into here. Come down this way, and build a couple of steps. And again, you could build one here if you wanted to basically wrap this one around, and it will go up. So I'll just do the same on here, just to make sure that they all connect up. Like this, I've got one this way, and one this way. If I go through the whole admin floor here, there we go. So then we've got that, and I'll just bring up this one here. So now what we're going to do is you're going to cut out 7 with grey wool. So you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Just like that. And the next one is going to be going out in 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Like that. And the next one is going to be a 7. So you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And again, just add a 3x3 box with this. And we'll do exactly the same as we've done this one. So again, if you're on Xbox or PS3, you can do your kind of switch out with these. And just put these down straight on top of the grey wall. Just like that. And then we'll do it the same on the other side as well. So add 7. So you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And a 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Another 3x3 box, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Just like this, and build your kind of anchor system type of thing, your chain system even. So these like this, and we'll go. Pull these ones back, and attach them in. Like that. So that gives us our chain system for the time being. So it's quite, it's not really simple, but it's not too bad. So now what we're going to do is we're going to build these 2 guns. So I'll just show you where they actually go. They are exactly the same as the back, but I will still go through them with you guys, as it can be a little bit tricky. So let's do this. Okay, now for the big guns, what we need to do is just on this middle pack, kind of part here, we're going to count back 6, so you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And just like the back one, we're going to build these in exactly the same way. So we'll just take these off, so you've got 5, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, like that, and then grab your cobblestone slabs and put these around them again, just like this. Like that, then grab your stone stairs, and again, just wrap these around like that. Oh, and I can actually get these right, which apparently I can't at the minute. There we go. Like this, and just wrap them around. And eventually we'll get all the way back. There we go. So, just like that, and I'm just going to count where and how far back we need to go for this one. Okay, and it's exactly the same as the last one, so we've got a 3-block gap, 1, 2, and 3. And this is where we'll have our cobblestone slabs. So for the first, what we'll do is just go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 1. 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 1. Just like that, and then build this up to 4, so you get 1, 2, 3, and 4. Just make this one a bit higher. Like this. And we're almost done with this one. And then again, grab your cobblestone slabs. This one will go all the way around, but for the time being, actually just put it all the way around. It does connect into the back part, as you can see here, but for the time being, just put your cobblestone slabs all the way around, and we can kind of cut them out later on, and grab your stone stairs and do the same. And I'll just skip this part and show you what to do next after it. And then what you need to do after you've done both of those, we'll just do the front one first, this one here. So you've got 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, straight on top. You got 1, then you got 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And then you're going to have a 1, and then a 3, 1, 2, and 3. So 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 2 sets of 1, and then you go 3 here, like that. And then just fill in these ones here. I'll just show you how to do the bottom one, and then you can just copy onto the top. Because this one doesn't have an aircraft on it, you don't actually have to put on that little bit, so it is built exactly the same way as this one here. So then you need to add an extra 5 on the front like this. And then, like just like we did before, we're just going to count back 3 of these. So we got 1, 2, and 3, and then we got 5 on the back, or behind it even. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Take off this bit here, fill in the floor like this. Then we're going to go back and we're going to have 5, so you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and a 3, 1, 2, 3, and then 3 across the back. So 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And just like before, what we'll do is have these stone slabs on the sides. Like this. And then we're just going to build up this one again. But this time this one goes straight over the back, of course. And this bit, it gets left out. So 3 here. Just like this. And drag this back, and then fill in the roof. Just like this. Which will give you that. Then grab your black wool, and then add 12. So you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, add 12. Go into the middle, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, add 12. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. And then grab your block of iron, put 2 in here, 2 in here. Put stone slabs on these parts, and then another brick slab right on the top, bit like that. And just to finish this one off, you just need to add your 2 pieces of light grey wool, or if you made it out of light grey wool, stone or something like that, and put your buttons around it. So same on the other side. Just like this. And then copy this onto this gun here. And we'll do a couple of the side details, there's just a couple just on the side, and then we're going to get onto the main bit. Okay, now for all the minor details. So if we just come to this front gun, you should have both of them now. I just put in 2 blocks here, and then put 2 stone slabs. So these are in line with these kind of 2 front ones before you get onto the 5, it's just got a 1 block gap. So that you can actually walk around this part here. So it's the same on the other side. So 1 block gap, 2 stone slabs, 2 stone thingamajiggies, and then you've got this kind of 3 gap here. We're just going to leave a 1 block gap. Again, 1 block gap this way. It's going to be 3, and this time it's going to be 2 wide as well, so you've got 3 by 2, and put your stone slabs on the top. So again, so you've got this one in line. It's 1 block gap here, so you bring this one back to here. And then just put this on top like that. That just gives it a little bit extra detail. You can put these up kind of everywhere, really. But you don't want to put too many of them on there. It also means if you guys are turning this into, for example, a PvP map, you've actually got places where people can kind of hide behind, which is quite cool. So now what we're going to do is we're just going to go on to the next section where we've got these five secondary guns. And all of them are kind of weird angles as well. But we'll do that and we'll get on to the next layer. Okay, so now we're setting up this kind of back part. What we'll do is we'll just take off these back couple of slabs here. So you've just got these kind of ones here. This wall here, which can extend by an extra one. So actually, for the time being, if we just put down one block, and then we'll kind of build it up. I'll tell you how many to build it up for after that. Then we have a one, one, one. So we've got three sets of one going this way. Then a three, one, two, and a three. Then we've got a one. Then a three, one, two, three. And then a one. And now an 11. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, and 11. And next one's going to be 11 as well, so you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. Then you're going to go back and do a 10, so you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Then you got a 1, a 1. I don't know why I said that so weird. And then you got a 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4. And then the rest of these are just going to be straight on top like this. Let's build all of those up. So do the same on the other side, just for this kind of basic part. And build it up to a layer of a total height of 3 like that. So just go 1, 2 and 3, build that up all the way around just on this part and do it on the other side as well, and we'll get on to the next layer. Okay, and then once you've done that, we're going to do the next bit, which is just kind of outlining basically this ship. So we're just going to go on this third level here, I'm just going to add an extra block to most of the outside of it. So just outlining this here. And then when we get to this point here, this one would be going out just a little bit. What we're going to do is add an extra block here and extend this out again. So you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. And if we just outline this normally here, then we just add an extra block in there to kind of build that up. And we can also just, for the time being, just fill this in solid with that. And if we just bring this all the way to the back and just leave it here, because there is a little bit different when it goes up onto these crane type bits, we'll actually do that a bit later. So we've kind of got this kind of extension here, so hopefully you guys haven't got stuck with that. I'll do the same on the other side as well with you guys. So just basically just add an extra block to the outside of this, like this. When we get to here, what we're going to do is we're just going to go out and also add this bit. So you're basically just adding, where you've got this wall that comes forward, so just add two, and then just make it a little bit more kind of smooth. So then you've got 11 here, so you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. And then if we just go back again, and then we could just fill this bit in for the time being. And just go around here, and just add it to there. Now if you grab your oak wood planks, we can actually cut out most of this, as long as it's kind of all joined, because we will be doing like we did it on the front and the back. With the actual iron, we're going to be doing that. So if you just take out this top layer part, and we can actually just start putting in the next floor. So if you guys just kind of fill in your floor, you should only have, unfortunately, a 2 roof gap. If you do want higher, then you could raise up this floor, I guess. But this is kind of to scale as possible with most of my builds. So if you just now, take out these kind of parts until you've just got these kind of connected around, and fill in the floor on this, we'll get on to the next layer after that. Okay, so for the next thing we need to do is we're just going to set up for these two cranes that we've got here. So just come to the back and come into here, and we're going to go up. So we've basically got one block around this part here. We'll finish off the back going around as well. We're just going to go up by 19, so you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, and 19. If we also grab a stone slab over here and just throw that on top, also just come down one block and add 18 blocks. So you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. So this will just be the basis. We'll actually do this in a second. Might as well put this in now. So you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. Stone slab on the top. Come down by one block, add 18, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. Just like that. And another thing we can do here is just add iron bars going across here. You could, if you wanted, 2-foot stairs going up to this section. So if we just put these across here. And then if we grab a block of iron and just extend this one by one, and then have one going there, so you've just got this one going one extra, and one, then a two, and that just goes into a one here. You could, if you wanted to, just have it going straight across, but I went for this for some reason, but I'm not too sure why. And then you can just put in your oak wood, and also switch out. You can have a couple of blocks there. So now, same for the other side. What you're going to do is extend this by one. Then you have a one, and then a two, and then just a one that connects into here, and then join them up. Get rid of the blocks we don't actually need, and put in your kind of oak wood. And we can also join these ones up as well at the back. This is actually going to go up by a couple of blocks, so you can just add a couple extra blocks on it. Though, as it'll be this kind of back mass, this is the main kind of one that goes all the way up, and you can grab your iron bars, and you can actually put these all the way around now, and wrap them around until it connects into the front, and also at the back. All I did at the back here is I just tried to connect it around, and it goes all the way around here, and it just stops there, because there's actually a ladder that goes up here, so you need a way in. So go around with your iron bars, and I will show you what to do next. Okay, then once you've done that, we'll finish off these cranes because they're looking pretty terrible at the minute. So what we're going to do is we're just going to count up six. So you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then on the sixth, what we're going to do is we're just going to go around the entire kind of base of it, just like this. And then on the seventh one, we're going to add two, this, and then another two, and we're basically going to continue this pattern until we hit into the top of it like that. So just get this for now, and grab your stone slab, and go around it with your stone slab, like this. And then got one more block here, and just add a block on each of them. And I have a stone slab on the bottom of each of these as well, like that. And also on the top, like that. And then if you grab your nether brick, if we just take out this one, we're just going to have a couple of pieces of nether brick fence on these here. And also on the top of this. Grab some nether brick fence and bring it all the way to the top, and then here add about 3 or 4. Actually, it's really up to you. I think I used 3 on this one. 1, 2, 3, and I'm going to go down by 4. Add 1 to each kind of side, just like this. And then that's it for the crane kind of style. So you can just copy it straight onto this one. And then what we'll do is we're going to build this back mast first, and we will probably lay out the basic part of this deck. Well, not this deck, the main bridge kind of command section. We'll probably lay out the basic part of it and then put in the boats, because it might be easier to do it, do this part first without having to fill all around. So we'll probably just do the first layer of this and just fill it in, and then finish off the kind of minor details going around that deck. And then it's just a little bit left, so let's do this. Okay, so for starting off this backmast type thing up here, what we're going to do is we're just going to go up by 9, so just count this one. Here, so we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9, just like that. Then what we're going to do is, where we've got this kind of diagonal corner here, if we just go to this side, it might be a bit clearer. So I've kind of got these, a couple going that way, and a couple going that way, and we've just got this kind of corner here. This one's going to go up by 5, so you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Same on the other side, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Then put a stone slab on the top of this one. I'm then going to go diagonal to here and go up 5, 5. So you've got a diagonal. It's on the same kind of side as the slab there. So you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Same on the outside as well. 2, 3, 4, 5. Grab your stone slab. This will go on the other side as well. Just to kind of try and make it look like it's more joined in together. That was really difficult. Same with this one here. Just join the one to the top there. And then go diagonal again and in. So then 5 again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 4, 5. And then go 5 there, underneath, join those on, join them onto this part here, and then instead of going inwards this time, we're just going to go up by 2 like this, and 2, and then again, your slabs, and then by 2 yet again, like this, This will connect into the main kind of section. It gives us a really good kind of place where everything kind of will tie in later on, but we're currently, if we just keep that one at 9, I'll do this kind of section that goes out here, which connects into these two front parts, then we'll go basically go up section by section with this. Okay, and then grab your stone slabs, and just on the back of this one here, we're going to go back by 4 blocks, so you get 1, 2, 3, and 4, and then just put down a block of iron or something, and put your stone slab on top. I just put a cobblestone wall on each side like this. If you haven't got a cobblestone wall, never brick fence will do fine. It's just some sort of centre type thing. And then on this front part here, we're going to add 3, so you got 1, 2, and 3. Then if we go to the side here, we're going to go 1, 2, 3, and 4. And next one's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And then after that, all you need to do is just go 1, 2, and 3, 4 on this part, this kind of side bit here. So it just goes back to here like that. The same on the other side as well, so you've got 1, 2, 3, and 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, like that, and then 1, 2, 3, and 4, just on the side like that. And then just to finish off this level, all you need to do is grab your iron bars and just bring these around the outside, and you can connect them around the back, to this section here, like this, and this is where it gets really messy, unfortunately, just on that back part, like here, it gets super, super messy. Also, when you do start pulling out this, you won't be able to actually get to this back section here. So you could extend this, but again, this is more accurate to the actual model itself rather than anything else. So what we can also do here is cut out this one. And if we get our ladder, we can actually add that up as we're going down. So get your ladder and you can put this up like that. And that's how we get up to this section. So let's move on to the next one. And then what we need to do is just extend this part here by 4, so you go 1, 2, 3, and 4. Then grab your stone slabs again, and there's just going to be 1 on the back part this time, instead of going back by 4, so then you've got 1 here, and it's 5 wide in total, so just add 2 to each side. Then on the front of this one, what you're going to do is add 6, so you get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, and this is just 3 wide, just in this front part, and then just connect these two like this. And again, you can cut through this part here and put in your ladder if you want to. So I actually advise doing that as you're going through. So then you've got that like that. Okay, and then if we come to the front part, and we're just going to go forwards here and make a 3x3 box like this. So we've got these 3 showing here, and then we've got this 3x3 box here, and same on the other side, so we've just got a 3x3 box like that. Where we've got this kind of back part, we can actually connect this in here if you just connect these two together. So we've got this 5 here, and we're actually going to go out again and make a 3x3 box. So we've got 1, 2, 3, like that. And if we connect these two together like this and add an extra block in there. So create yourself a 3x3 box. So you've got 1, 2, 3, like this. Connect these two again, and then you've just got an extra one. Just like that, so it kind of creates this crazy-ish shape. So then what you can do is you can grab your iron bars and put these around the outside of these, just like this. And wrap these around most of the kind of top part, so like that. And then what we're going to do is we're going to create these kind of spotlight type things. So I use cobblestone wall, you can use never brick fence if you're on Xbox or PS3. Then put a light grey piece of wall, or anything else, you could use white wall as well. Put trapdoor going towards the front for these two, so you've got a trapdoor on there. And then you've got buttons just going around the sides of them. It's the same here, so you've got wool, buttons around it, like this. And then you've also got them on here as well. And also what you could do if you wanted to is you could put a glowstone on these. But it's really up to you. But of course you can't put the buttons on if it's got glowstone on it, so depends what you want to do. But that's it for that layer, so let's go on to the next one. Okay, and for the next one, just add 3 blocks. So you've just got 1, 2, and 3. And then to the front, all you're going to do is add 4 slabs. So if I can actually fit between these, so you've got 1, 2, 3, and 4. Which bring you just in line with here. It's just going to be 3 wide, and it doesn't go back right to this part here either. So then once you've done that, also on the back there's 4 cobblestone wool or never brick fence, which will just connect into this back part here. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. Just put that in there. Grab your iron bars and put these around the sides of it. So of course you can't put them in there, but you can put them on the front. So you kind of get this small, or really small kind of viewing area. And again, cut your hole through and put in your ladder to get up onto this section, and we'll get onto the next one. And then the next bit, what you're going to do is you're going to add 4 blocks. So you got 1, 2, 3, and 4, just like this. And on the back, you're going to add 1 block here and go across by 3. You're going to have 3, 1, and then a 3. So you've just got that kind of shape on top of it, like that. If you grab your slabs as well and just put these around, just like this. And also, if we add an extra block in here, that'll connect in to the kind of these that are going back, it's like that. And we can also put in an extra slab underneath these, like that. And also a slab on each of these kind of corners as well to round it off. And if we just go down here, and we'll just cut through this one and this one, just to put in our ladder. So we'll put in our ladder there, like that. I guess you could also, if you want to, come across here. It's really up to you. But then what we're going to do on top of this is we're going to have, on top of this slab, we're going to have 3. We're going to have 1 here, and this one will go out. So kind of got this 2 shown here, then 3 across. Same over here, so we've got this 3. This kind of 2 showing that it goes across, like that. So we've got this kind of odd shape here, so I'll just give you an area of that so you can make sure you've got it. And I think what we could actually do here is put in an extra block there. That might make it look better. Or what we can do is just put in a slab as well. That might also work. So this then creates this kind of small room. Then grab your glass. You can put that just directly on top, like this. And then grab your block of iron or your hull colour again and put this directly on top as well. This is a kind of bigger observation deck. Well, not observation deck, but observation of place, which gives you a nice kind of view. Well, not really that nice of a kind of view, but gives you a view. So we'll get on to the next one. Okay, and then for the next one, what you're going to do is you're just going to have a 3 and then a 3. So you're only really going in on the sides here. So you just go on the sides, and this again, just go up by 1, and then you have your glass, and then you'll have your roof on top as well, just like before. And if we go inside, we can then also bring this up just to that level and put your your ladder on it, like that. And we need to put in the floor as well, which is the same as the kind of roof level. So just put in your floor here. Then we'll get these kind of smaller ones, so they are too high. We get to the next one here. We can also might as well put in our roof here, like that. And the next one is going to be a 1, 1, 1. So it's just progressively getting smaller as you go up. And again, put your glass on top like this, and then put your blocks on top like that. And then what you need to do is, if you just fill in this roof as well, actually bring up this first. So this kind of last one is pretty useless because you can't actually walk around. As you can see, you can't really get into any of the other sections, which is a bit of a shame, but there's not much we can do about it. And bring up this again, and then fill in these kind of holes there. And you've just got this extra hole here, go up by 1 block like this. And then what you're going to do is just come and basically outline what you've done on the last layer just with your stone slabs for the time being, like this. And then what you're going to do is you're just going to add an extra slab onto all of them, so it just extends this kind of shape by an extra couple of blocks, like that. So you're just overhanging basically by 1. Grab your block of iron, and you're just going to go straight on top of these, like this, and then cut out your kind of ladder space to actually go up. So you could either, you could just stop it at this kind of level here, so that you can actually cut through these and just have this layer, so you can actually go up here and have a look, or you can just extend this all the way up until you get onto right at the top here, which is pretty damn high up. But you've got that. And then just on this back one here, you're just going to put a nether brick fence and go up by 7. So you've already got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Just like that. So what we're going to do now, just on this back part, is there's a couple more kind of poles and things like that to actually come out the side. So I'll put those in, and then we're done with this back mast. So you're doing really well. Okay, the first one I'm going to do is just on this back section here. like what we've got here, we're just going to go down, and I can go out, so you go down by two and then go out, and then this one goes straight down until it hits into that, we put in that cobblestone wall a bit later, a bit earlier on, and it should just connect straight into it like that. And then what we're going to do is, just on this side here, we're going to add five, so we've got this bigger one, this bigger kind of section type thing here, and just towards the front, instead of it being directly on centre, I put it slightly on the side. You could, if you wanted to, put it straight on centre, it's up to you. Add five, one, two, three, four, and five. Do the same on the other side. One, two, three, four, and five, just like that. And then just where we've got this intersection here, we're going to add four. So you've got one, two, three, and four. We move on to the other side. Just add four. One, two, three, and four. Just like that. And that finishes off that back tower. So you can see that it's actually got it's quite a lot of detail in this. So now we'll just move on to doing the first kind of level of the main command bridge section. And get all of this sorted. And then we can actually move on to the detailing around it, and then just keep on moving up, and we'll be done soon. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're going to just set up for the main kind of command bridge section. So if you come to the front gun that we've got here, there's going to be a 5-block gap. So you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Then what we're going to do is you're going to have a 5 across. So you've got 1, 3, 4, and 5. Just going straight across like this. We have a 1, 1, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And this one goes back, kind of has this 2 going this way, it's kind of hard to explain. Might as well do the same on the other side as well, so we've got 1, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then this one kind of corners in like this. Then you're going to have an 8, so you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. So you have side 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And then just join these two together like that. Okay, then what you need to do is just raise this one up to a total height of 4 for the time being, so you've got 1, 2, 3, and 4. So if you just completely kind of raise this one up, and I'll get back to you. Then that will give you this kind of rough shape. There is these kind of arches and things where it kind of goes out, which we are going to do in a second. If you just come to the back of this, where we go towards these kind of cranes, let's leave a 2-block gap right here. And we're going to build the actual smokestack, because it's really easy, and it's kind of semi kind of detached off it. So there's going to be 3 across here. And we can get rid of these now. And then there's going to be 1 going back on each side like this. So we've got this kind of 2 showing here. Then we've got 3, so you've got 1, 2, and 3. So we've got 3 across the back like this. So you get this kind of shape like that if we're facing, that's the front of the ship there. So hopefully you guys have got that. And now all you have to do is just make this a total height of 13. So you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and 13. So then just raise all of that to a total height of 13, I'll tell you what to do next. Okay, and now we're going to do the 3 arches that you can see just on the bottom here. So what you need to do is come back 3 blocks, so you've got 1, 2, and 3, and because this is kind of going outwards, you've got one here, and just bring this going all the way up like that, and then just going to add 2 blocks here, and 1 here, as it is going backwards slightly. Grab your stone brick stairs, that's what I've used anyway, and just put them in there so you've got your arches. And then what we're going to do is there's going to be another one, so you're going to have another 3-block gap, 1, 2, 3. This one's actually in line, so it's normal. Let's join it across. And then put in your archways again, just with your stone brick stairs. If you don't like that at all, what you can do is just put in a normal block in here as well. You can do something like this, which also doesn't look too bad. I just prefer the actual look of stairs because they're a bit more rounded. I don't feel as heavy, so do that. And then another 3-block gap, 1, 2, and 3. And this one's going forward, so you've got an angle, so you've got this here. There's just going to be 1 on this side, and then 2 on this side, on the back part, like that. And on the back of this one, add 3 blocks, 1, 2, and 3. And this one goes across the back by 2, so you've got these 2 shown here. And you've got 2, and then you should have a 1 where it connects right into the back section like that. Now what you have to do, again, get your stone brick stairs and put these in just there. So you're just building the kind of framework for this, really. And if we go to the other side as well, so you've got 1, 2, 3, moves here, like this. I'll just have to double check here, so you've got 2 here, 1 here, 1, 2, 3, build your pillar like this. You know a 3-block gap, 1, 2, 3, because it's staggered, of course, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then this one only has 1 block here, and then 2 here, add three blocks at the end. 1, 2, 3. 2 here, and it goes in towards it, towards the smoke funnel, so 2, and then 1, which connects up there. And then we've got this here, like that, and all we have to do to finish it off is grab your stairs or just your normal blocks and put them in the arches to actually create those arches like that. Okay, and grab your blocks of iron or your hull colour and just on these back bits, just build this up an extra layer. Leave these ones here. So just on these back here, like this. And if we come to the front, just off this one here, what we're going to do is we're going to come forwards on these two like this, and then this one comes across. And just on this back part where we've got this solid wall, what we're going to do is we're just going to create this extra little bit that sticks out. And this is just basically just a place where somebody can kind of stand and look over like this. And then just connect on two here, and just two on that section there. So we'll do the same on the other side here. So we've just got this block here, we're going to come forwards and have two across here. This will just go pretty much straight back, and we're going to create this kind of extra bit with three blocks. So we've just got this tiny little bit here. These two are there, and these two are there. And then if we grab our oak wood planks, we can just put these through. We will actually have to pull up, like we did with the back one, mass, we will actually have to pull up the kind of tripod legs through this kind of entire section as well. But what we'll do is if we just leave this kind of basic section, I'll then do that after we've done all the side guns and put that in so that we can actually completely focus on it. But you just fill in this entire section, and then also if you just connect these two bits and grab your iron bars and put these around like this, just on that kind of section there. The front, there's a slight different bit, there's this kind of blob at the front, so we'll actually do that later on as well, but just put in your floor for now. Okay, and before I forget, we're just going to put in the secondary guns, so come to the front, and where we've got this kind of front deck where the big guns are, we just leave a one block gap, then we can have cut out this one, put in grey wool, and just do three of these, like this. And then just for the gun, what you need to do is just do three diagonal slabs, like that. So it'll be the same on the other side, so I'm only going to show you on one side. I'll move on to the next one. And the next one is just in here, so where we go onto this kind of longer run here, which is going to cut out this, and do exactly the same. So we've just got one, two, and three, just like that. So we've got that on there. And then the next one is on this kind of extended section, so we're just going to have one here, and then two of them are on the kind of main run. And again, just going to have these three. So it does stop you from being able to walk around if you can actually get in here. To stop you from being able to get around all the way on this one, unfortunately. And the next one is the same, so you've just got this kind of one on this side here, and these two get cut out of this section, and this time they're going to go diagonally kind of backwards. And then we've got the last one, which is just in this section, where we've just got them kind of on these two, like this, and you've just got your diagonals. Again, like that. So that's the five guns. So you got 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. While I'm here, I might as well go through them on the other side as well. So you've just got a one block gap here, then you've got these three, 1, 2, and 3. Then you've got your diagonals, 2, and 3, like that. And then the next one is just on this one here. So you've got 1, 2, and 3, like this. And I'm putting your diagonal stone slabs, and then on this midsection, got one just before it, and then two of these get cut out and swapped out, and then you got your threes again, like this, and on the back as well, one here, and you've got your two sections here, and then right on the back as well, these two get cut out, and this one's just there. Just cut these out. Like this. And then we've got the secondary guns, so then I haven't forgotten about those, so we'll move on to the next bit. Okay, now if we just finish off this front part, if you just add five blocks here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, straight on top, then you've got 2, then you've got 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 2. This just goes 2 high in total, like this. And if you want, what you can actually do now is just grab your stone slabs, just put them on top of this part, like this. And also come across the roof. I'm not really too sure what this place is. You could have a really tiny room if you want to, or you could actually use this, make a small door, and actually have this as kind of some stairs going down, possibly into the last kind of lower layer. But for now, we're just going to do it like that. So now what we're going to do is just finish off all these side details and we'll go on to the next part. Okay, so for some of these side guns, which is what we're going to be doing now, if we just come to this front part where you got the main big gun, you've got two of these, so you got one, two, and then this one here, you're going to switch out for a full block here, then another one, and another one, so you're going to have three in diagonals like this. Take out these extra ones behind it. And on the sides, you're going to have two, so you're basically going to have this two, and then a one, like that. Now if you grab your stone brick, we're just going to place one here, and one here, you get your stone brick stairs, and just put them on like this. So you've got one facing forwards, one facing kind of to the side. Put your upside down stairs as well, and just two stone slabs like this. Like that, and we'll do the same on the other side because it's really easy. So you've got one, two, cut out this one here, you've got three diagonals. Cut in the back now, and just take out these. You've got two, one, and two like that. Grab the stone bricks, place them down, and you've got one going to the side, and one going to the front. And then you've got your two upside downs like that, with, well, two stone slabs like that. And then for the next one we're going to do is, it's just one block away from this, we're going to cut out these two here and have our two here. And you've got three, so you've got one, two, three, and then you've got another two. So then just take out this one here, and then this one is built kind of like the ones at the back where you just got these two stone brick blocks. And again you've got your stairs, and you've got your upside down stairs, two stone slabs. So all it is just one block there. We'll do the same on the other side as well. So come to this side, it's just got one block gap, we're going to cut out these two, and you've got two here. One, two, and three, and then two, stone brick here, stone brick stairs, upside down, stone brick stairs, two slabs, like that. And then the next one, if we just count four of these, you got one, two, three, four, and we're going to the fifth. That's where we place our extra one there, so you got one, two, three, and four there. This is where we're going to have our three like this, then just do two kind of twos on the side. And exactly the same with your stone bricks. Stone brick stairs, upside down, and then your stone brick slabs, so we'll go to the other side as well, like this, so 1, 2, 3, 4, and then the 5th, 1, 2, and 3, then go to 2 here, 2 here, stone brick stairs, and upside down, and then you just got your stone slabs like that. And then when we've got this part that goes out here, we're just going to do count back three. So you got one, two, three, and then you go onto the fourth. And again, cut out these three. You get your two. And yet again, with your stone brick thing. So the guns are pretty much exactly the same all the way through. So I won't keep on going over them. So you've got one, two, three, and then the fourth. This is where you're going to place it. Twos, twos, and then put in your guns like this. Place down rope slabs like that. And then the next one is on this run here. And we're just going to leave a one block gap and then go onto this and have three. So you've got this one block here from this kind of long run, not counting this side gap here. I get twos, and then exactly the same for your guns like this. And the same on the other side, so we'll just fly over here. One block up, then you're going to have your threes. One, two, three, and twos. Like this. Stone brick. And then like that. And like that. So that's actually all of the gun emplacements on the ship, actually. So we've done that now. What we'll do is we'll put in these boats and a couple of these smaller kind of details here. Then we can just keep on building upwards. Okay, so first thing we're going to do is build two of the small boats. We've got two small boats and two kind of larger ones. The small boats are exactly the same as this one here, so they're pretty simple, but I'll still go through them. So where we've got this kind of, I'm not sure what you call this part, but the observation-y type thing, you're going to have a two-block gap, so you've got two blocks here. Then on either side, you're going to have these stone bricks like this, leave a three-block gap, one, two, and three. So you've got three blocks in here as well, one, two, three. And then if you go to the other side with a one block gap and put in more stairs like this, I'll just put in the basis for the other side as well, but because these two are exactly the same, you guys can kind of do that pretty easily. Then build up some way to put your upside down stairs and then have your upside down stairs like this. And then on the front again, you're just going to come forwards, you got one, two, three, four, five, and then one extra on the back. And get rid of this rubbish in here. stone slabs goes, not stone slabs, quartz slabs go straight on top. Again, if you're on Xbox or PS3, choose your other kind of colour, whatever it is. And then again, you can put on these ones on the back, put in your floor as well. And actually place these blocks correctly like that, and then put in those there. So do the same on the other side, and we'll get onto the two big boats. And then for the big one, what you're going to do is these kind of supports are in the same place. So all you need to do is just have a 3-block gap. So you got 1, 2, 3. You got support. Then you have a 5-block gap. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And put in a support. And of course, mirror this on the other side as well. So just take out these kind of guide blocks. I also recommend, of course, putting in these kind of guide blocks on the other side. Again, I'll just show you how to do it on one side, and you can copy it over. So then. Way to do is if you build a block up on this one, so it's going to be 5 wide this boat, so you've basically got to move yourself forwards, and you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7, and then come forwards with one, and then come forwards with another. And what I recommend doing is just at the minute building away so that you can actually again place a block, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7, and then come forwards yet again, just like this. And then what you're going to do on the back is you're going to have a slab on these parts here, and then 3 upside down stairs like that. And again, grab your slabs, put them straight on top. Actually, I recommend leaving a 3-block gap at the back, it gives it a bit more shape. Just lay these straight on top, grab your birch wood or whatever type of slabs you've been using for the floor, and just put these in right on the front. This time put in a full block here so that you can actually cover up this gap there. So just recommend putting in a 4-block of quartz or whatever material you've got. Just put it on the floor like normal, like that. And then this time, go across again, and you can actually make a couple of these like that, which gives you a kind of bigger boat, which has got the back as well. You could, if you wanted to, go straight across the back, but I think it adds a lot more shape if you've actually got them off like that. So copy that onto the other side, and we've just got a couple more details. And then for some of the minor details, like we had these ones here, just put a couple on the back here. So if you leave a 4-block gap, 1, 2, 3, 4, from this kind of main crane, put in 2 blocks with your stone slabs on top. I'll just show you how to do it on one side, and you guys can copy onto the other. But there isn't that much. And directly in line with this, all I did is we've got this one here. I just added an extra 2 here and put on the stone slabs. Another thing you can do with all of these small box type bits is grab your buttons and put them around the side as well. If you really want to add a little bit more detail, it's really up to you if you want the plain ones or you want them with buttons. I'm just going to do it plain because it's easier for me while teaching, but at least I've given you a couple of ideas. So just copy that little tiny detail onto the other side, and we are actually done with this entire kind of back bit. And now we're just going to keep on kind of building up. I think what we'll do quickly is actually just finish off this smokestack because it's really easy. So let's get to it. Okay, so for finishing off the smokestack, if you grab cobblestone wool, or also if you haven't got the cobblestone wool, use never brick fence, and just go in right up the back part here, all the way up the back, and then from this point here, add 4. So you've got 1, 2, 2, I have to double check that, 2, 3, and 4, like that. So, and now what we're going to do is if we just grab black wool and put 3 here, 3 here, and 3 here, so we're basically just doing this 3, 3, 3, 3 circle, and grab stone stairs. I'm just going to wrap these around this part here. Where we get to this here, we put in 3 pieces of cobblestone, and then continue to wrap it around like this. And that gives us this kind of shape here. So then what we're going to do is come on the inside and go down by one layer just to give a bit more depth. And just create one small kind of circle in here, and you can actually go in further. I'll just cut the way out later on and just go down again. It's really up to you for that kind of part. It just creates this kind of hole. If you grab another brick fence and just put these around the size of it, again it gives it a little bit more detail. And then if you want to, you can grab cobweb to make some kind of smoke, and just bring this up. And there's really no easy way to do this and make it look right other than just messing around. And I have no idea if that looks alright or not. Yeah, it looks kind of alright. So You can put in a little bit of cobweb like that, and that will finish off the kind of main part of the smokestack. There is still these kind of side bits that are attached to it, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to keep on building up because it might make it a little bit too close to the actual main part here. So let's do this. Okay, so if we just build up again, if we just leave a two block gap here, go across by 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and this one here is going to go back by 3, so you got 1, 2, and 3. So on the other side, then what's going to happen is it goes out and does 3, 1, 2, and 3. I'm going to go out by 2, so just got 2 here. We just do the same on the other side, 3, and then we've got 2. This one actually goes inwards by 2, so it's really, really small, so you've just got this kind of weird shape like this. We got 3, 1, 2, and 3. So on the other side, and it just connects across by 5, so you got 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, like that. If for the time being we just build up to a height of 3, like this. So just go all the way around it. Don't put any floor in yet, because it kind of has a bit of an overhang on this one. But if we just put this in for now, like that, what we'll now do is we'll just do a couple of the minor details that are around it, and we'll move up to the next level. And we're just going to put in one of those kind of flashlight type things, the light type things up here. So we come to this back section and just go onto this block here, cobblestone wool, light grey wool, trapdoor, and then your buttons. So again, you can switch that out if you're on one of the console versions and you don't have this. This, put your buttons around like that, and that actually finishes up the bottom kind of layer. So now we'll do the outline for this building here. And then if we just kind of set up this the kind of outline of it, what we're going to do is if we come forwards off this block here, 2, and then this is going to be 5 across. So extend it by quite a bit. Then we're going to do is we're going to go back and we're going to have 3, so you've got 1, 2, and 3. Next one's a 3, 1, 2, and 3. Next one's 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And there's going to be 9 going across the back, so we're just going to add 2 blocks to this side. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. And if we could complete the other side as well, so we've got 3, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, and a 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 and 5. So these have only kind of too high. What you can now do is just come in to this part and for the time being just cut out all of it like this, and then you can fill in your floor. So fill this floor in and we'll get on to the next part. Okay, so we're going to put in a little bit of these supports as we go up that's actually support this part, just like we did on the back going up here. But of course it cuts through the deck. So we come underneath these arches, and where we've got the main kind of section here, we're just going to go diagonal off this block here and go 1, 2, 3. You might actually want to cut through here, so you've got 3, 4. So 1, 2, 3, and then this floor here is 4, 5, and 6. Then put a slab on. Then it's going to count this one here, and then we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So if we do the same on the other side as well, come here, go diagonal, you've got 1, 2, cut through, 3, 4, 5, 5 and 6, put on your slab, and this one counts, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Just putting in those kind of basic parts of the time being. Okay, and now if we just go one block back from this part and go across by 3, so we've just got this kind of one block of wood there, and this one's going to go back by 3, counting that block, so you get 1, 2, and 3, 2, 3, then we've got 3, and another 3, like that. So it's a pretty simple shape, and it's a pretty small kind of building. The walkway just about goes around it. Build that up to a total height of 3 as well. And just go all the way around. Again, it will change slightly, but this at least gives us a good basis to kind of work off. Just go around like this. And if you grab your iron bars and just wrap these around the walkway, to go around to the back and also across this part here. This. So you can't actually walk around most of this part just because it's pretty much impossible. You could always just take out these ones like that and have those like that, but I kind of prefer it kind of linking in. You could also just add an extra block here and here and here and then link them in there, but it doesn't look as accurate, so we've just got that for the time being. And then we're going to do the same as we did before, just creating this overhang. So come to the front, add 3. I'm going to have a 1, then a 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. Another 3, 1, 2, 3, and one more 3, 1, 2, and 3. Add an extra block to this one here, and then connect these two. So add an extra block there. If you come to the front, we've got a 1, 3, get rid of that block, 1, 2, 3, another 3, 1, 2, 3, and another 3, 1, 2, and 3. Like that, so it gives this kind of shape. And again, if we just come around, take off this roof type bit, take off the kind of extra pieces on the inside, and again, fill this up with your oak wood planks, and we'll get onto the next layer. And then the next one, go back by one block again, and you're just gonna have a 1 and a 3, 1, 2, 3, and a 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So 1, 3, and 4. So it does start to get really, really small. And again, build this up to a total height of 3. Like that. Grab your glass and just take out the first couple of layers. So you got 1, 2, 3, 4. So it's just the first kind of couple of sections like this. Grab your block of iron. Just on the front, you're going to go 3 here, and then 1, then 3. So these sections like that. And grab your iron bars, and then again wrap these around until it connects in the back, and again go straight across the back part here, and then wrap around like this. And on mine, what I actually did to make sure you can walk around is I just took off this block here, this iron bar actually, so that you can actually basically go around this section and get all the way to the front so you can actually look around. So again, yeah, you could do the same on the bottom as well. But now what we'll do is we'll just probably set up these kind of the bits that come out and go side for the tripod part, as it might make it a bit easier. And if we just go inside on this part by one block, so you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And then again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And then we're going to go in and also diagonal. So if we just go ahead, so you're going to go up and in by one diagonal like this. So you've got those two like that, and that goes up by 4, so you've got 1, 2, 3, and 4. It'll connect in later, so you've got 1, 2, 3, and 4. Just grab your stone slabs for the time being, just put them on the bottom and also on the top of these. Same on these parts here. We might take them out later on, but we might as well put them in here for now. So that gives us that kind of tripod part that kind of is building up that way. Okay, so just add one block to the front here, so you've got 2. And then you're going to have a 1 here, so that one's normal. Then a 2, just coming out on this part here. And you've got an extra 2, not there, there. So you've got 2, 1, 2, 2. Then we've got a 1. And then we've got a 2 going back and also across this way. And a 3, so you've got 1, 2, and 3. If you go around the back, it's going to switch directions again, so you've got 1, 2, and 3. Then you have a 1 like that, which will just come into here, and then this is going to go across by 5. So you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, and that'll count as 5. It is pretty complicated, it's not simple, fortunately, but it's, so you've got 2, 1, you're going to add 2 here, add 2 to the side of this part, then you have a 1 that comes out, then you've got a 2 that's going across, then you've got a 3 here, and across the back you've got another 3. And then you've got a 1, and that will connect into this 5, so it is a little bit more involved. Just like we did before, take out these parts. Just on this part, like that, and also grab your oak wood planks, or whatever type of wood you've used for the floor, and take it out. So this block here, we don't need, so you can switch that out for the wood. So switch the wooden planks out on the floor, and I'll show you what to do next. Okay, so if we go to the back of this kind of circular bit we've got here, right in the middle, put a cobblestone wall or never brick fence, and then with your iron block, go straight on top and just add one to each side. You're actually going to create a 3x3 box like this. And right in the middle, just go across by 3, so this is going on the side part. Grab your stone slabs and put these on either side, and then just grab a lever and just kind of point it downwards like that. Now what we're going to do is we're actually going to continue this cobblestone wall going down, so find out exactly where it is and just continue this down. It should connect into the side, a couple of these side parts here, and I'll go down until it just hits into here. So the reason I didn't put a stone slab on this part, which would have been the next beam, It's because then you can't walk through this kind of small section, especially with this. So this gives you this tiny walk like that. So do the same on the other side, and I'll get back to you. Okay, and grab a cobblestone wall again, or another brick fence. Right on this front part, just place a block. Two stone slabs on the top, and just put one on each side like this. Grab your iron blocks, and you're going to have 1, 2, 3, and 4. Just going straight on top like this. And then leave two block gap from the front. I'm just going to place down two blocks and put your stone slabs on top to create that kind of part there. Grab your iron bars. And then, yet again, just wrap these around like this. And just continue this going around. Like that. And that kind of completes that little section there. We're actually going to go back to this tower, not this tower, the smokestack, and just add this extra kind of strange box part that's on it. I don't know if it's for the cranes or... I'm not really too sure what it's for. We're just going to add it to the back of this, and then we can just continue and basically build another one of these observation towers, but they're pretty much identical. At least the actual kind of sizes on them are, with the all three, and then you've got these bits around here. It's just a couple of different differences, but we are almost done with the build, so you're doing really well. Okay, and then for the piece that goes on the side of this, what you're going to do is, where you've got this kind of level here, it's just going to be one higher. It's going to come out from this section by 2. Then this goes back by 6 in total, so you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And then goes across the side by 2 again. And then you're going to build this up to a total height of 4. So you've got 1, 2, 3, and 4. We'll just fill this in. And then if you grab your oak wood kind of planks and put these in just in the floor part like that. And grab your glass and just cut out these parts on this section here, just by 2 of these. And I'll leave a gap and have another 2 that's cut out like this. So it gives you this kind of small viewing area. You could, if you wanted to, cut out this one as well. That is really up to you. And then put in your oak wood planks on the top. And you're going to have 1, 2, 3, and 4 blocks towards the back like this. And iron bars going around. And if we just build the other one quickly. So you got a 2. This one goes back by 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Another 2, build up to 4. So you got 1, 2, 3, and 4. Just build this one up. Yes. Now grab your wood planks, put these in here, like this, and then grab your glass, let's just take that one out, put in 2 here, so you probably couldn't see that properly, but you got 2, then space in 2, put in your floor, first 4 are built up, so you got 1, 2, 3, and 4, iron bars around to this point, and then this back part just connects across. And you've got iron bars going there, so that's that kind of back section. I'm not that keen on it, it's a bit too big for my liking. It's a bit bigger than I actually wanted it, and I actually was thinking, while doing this actually, you could take out this floor, all of this floor like that, and use stone slabs instead. So you just have stone slabs going on it instead. And this might actually look a lot better. This. So I think that looks a bit better, as it looks a little bit more raised rather than this one, but it's really up to you. I'm going to switch mine out, and after that we're going to keep on building up. And then for building this other tower, what we're going to do is, where we've got this block here, leave a one block gap and go up by 3, so you've got 1, 2, and 3. Grab your stone slabs, and if we just go back until we hit the wall, we're just going to build a 3x3 box like this. And cut out here, then grab your ladder, and we can actually just put this ladder going up this way. So that'll bring it up to this section here, and again, iron bars you can put around just on these parts. This is a really, really short kind of observation type bit. And we're going to keep on building up, and then add an extra 3 blocks to this. So you got 1, 2, and 3. And then what you're going to do is grab your stone slabs, and on the front, just add a stone slab and go and add 2 to each side. And this will go back by 3, so you got 1, 2, and 3. And I just keep on going around with the stone slabs for this part. And just add one right at the back. Like that. Grab your cowl colour and just go around the sides with this. And then with your iron bars, you're just going to add one in right at the back here. And again, cut through and put in your ladder so you can get up. And this again is a pretty short kind of section. When this gets pulled up as well, you just kind of got this small viewing area. You can just about kind of walk around it. I'm just going to cut this back down again so I can tell you how many to add, but we'll get to the next one. And then again, add an extra 3 blocks to this. So you got 1, 2, and 3. And then add one on the front and add one to each side. And we're going to do 3, 1, and then 3 across the back again. So this is exactly pretty much the same as we did before with this one. Except for this time, we're not going to put these slabs in here because then you can't walk around. So we've just got this part like that. So you've got 3, 1, 3. Grab your slabs and just put them on the kind of outside of just this shape. But don't do it on these ones here. So we're just going to have a slab in here like that. And then exactly the same way we did these kind of 3 up here. We're basically going to do exactly the same. So we've just got 3 on the front. They've got 1 here that goes out by 2. This goes across like this. Then this one here is going to be a 3 as well. So you've got 1, 2, 3. You've got this kind of shape like that. So hopefully you guys have got that one there. And then if you grab your glass and put it around the outside again. And also straight on top as well for your roof. You can also cut out kind of floor here and bring your ladder up. Let's go 1, 2, 3 and bring your ladder up again onto these parts. Fill in your floor for the next layer as well. And now if you grab your never brick fence, and just in this groove here, we're going to add a never brick fence here and then go back here. So we've got 1, 2, and then we're going to zigzag. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, and 17. Like that. Same on the other side, so we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, and 17. Like that. Next one is gonna be same on this 3 here, then you got 3 on the side, 3 on the side. Like that, so it just goes in by 1, and again, glass straight on top. And then straight on top of this as well. Not there. Right across there. Bring this one up. Put your ladders on, going up. And then you can fill your floor in again. And again, we've got this really small one, which is pretty useless, but just the ones just going in like this. And again, glass. And put your roof on. And then this time, this is as high as it kind of goes, so this ladder can actually get you up into this one. You can actually look out of it for once, so it's not like the back one where you can't because it goes all the way to the top. But just fill in this kind of roof like this. Grab 2 slabs, and you're going to have 2 slabs just here. Then you're going to have a 3x3 box that kind of overhangs going towards the back of it. So you get that kind of shape that you've got 2 here and 3x3 box. Then raise up the last 3, also 1 right here. Actually, I think it's more like this. So that's 2x3 box, and then you got this one here. Right in the middle, put a cobblestone wall or, you know, brick fence or whatever. And I got by 2 more on here, and then just put some iron bars going around like that. And now all we've got to do is connect this into here, and I'll have a quick check, but we might be done with the build, so well done. Okay, so for just connecting the masts, all you need to do is just in this gap here, we've got underneath here, do 4 iron bars. So you got 1, 2, 3, and 4. What we're going to do is going to go down. If I can actually place them right, so 4, I'll just have to recount that. So you got 1, 2, 3, 4. Then there's going to be 1 down here, so if you touch the bottom, that'll count as another 1. So you got 1, 2, 3, and 4. And 1, 2, 3, and 4. 1, 2, 3, and 4. 1, 2, 3, and 4, and you basically keep going 2, 3, and 4 with exactly that kind of number. And then your last one should connect in perfectly. So then all you need to do is do the same thing just on the other side, because there's 2 of these. It's just in this groove, 1, 2, 3, 4, like that. do the same on the other side. I'm going to obviously skip that part because it's really easy. I'm going to have a quick check to make sure we've got everything. If we haven't, then you'll be near the end. Okay, and another bit of detail just to finish off this build. It's really simple, so we're just going to do a couple of kind of windows, and I've dropped down there, so it's going to be a couple of windows and where I've put the doors. So on this top section, I just put a door here, so you can do the same. I'm just going to cut out this and just throw that one down there, so if I can actually get out of this, there we go. So you've got that door there. Okay, now for the next one, what we're going to do, grab glass, and right at the front, there's going to be one here. On this free section, there's going to be a one, there's going to be another one, and another one, just like that. You can then put in a door at the back as well, possibly right in the middle. There we go, throw one right in the back, right in the middle, and as well, put in a glass on these sides as well, like that. So that's your next one, and next one down. It's pretty much the same on this, these kind of free sections. I'll just put one right on the back here. So you've got, on this bit, you've got those windows there, and I think on the front of mine here, I actually put in a door. This is kind of hidden underneath this part. So you can do the same on the other side as well. Like this, and put one in there. Another thing you can do on these small kind of bits that kind of jut out just a little bit, you can actually put in a gun, which you can do as a fence and a fence gate. So you can kind of put in a gun there. I've also seen some other people do this as well, with a fence gate, and actually knock these through. And that also looks pretty damn cool, so I'm actually going to keep that, and I might start doing that more often because it does look really, really cool. So all that is just having a fence gate going forwards, and then on the back, I'm going to go in this way, and I'm punching it through. And that does look really quite ace. So you guys can put that kind of detail on there. The only thing that we need to do now is put on a couple of these windows. So most of them are pretty much, like, kind of got a spacing between them, and I'll only show you how to do it on one side, of course, because it'll save me a lot of time going onto the other. So let's do this. Okay, so on this back part here, where we've got this kind of step pattern, we're just going to leave two of these blocks. You've got one, two. I'm going to just put in a window. Then you've got a three block gap, so you've got one, two, three, and then you're putting a window, one, two, three, window. And you just continue this pattern on, so you've got one, two, three, window, one, two, three, window, one, two, three, window. So it's just these three block gaps on that, one, two, three, window. And you just keep on going, basically. It's pretty self-explanatory. Like that, one, two, three, and another window. That, one, two, three. Two, three, one, two, three. That's right, yep. One, two, and three. So this one then goes back here. One, two, and three. One, two, three. And you could, I guess, put one on here. I think. Just trying to figure out exactly what I've done on this side. Yeah, so I did have that one in there, so that's fine. Or is that the same one? No, that's slightly different. So I've already done a slightly different pattern on this. It doesn't really matter with these ones. You can kind of choose a regular pattern. I'm just going to go with these three. So you got one, two, three. I'll put another one in. And one, two, three. One, two, three. And there. And I just went a couple forwards of this point here. So we'll continue that on. So you got one, two, three. One, two, three. And there. Two, three. And there. One, two, three. And then we'll just finish it off there, I think, for that kind of layer. So whatever you decide to do, I kind of recommend just doing what we've done there, starting with this kind of starting point, and just have a kind of pattern going all the way through the ship. So now what we'll do is we'll do the kind of where I've put the windows for underneath. This is with the deck set up being too high. So if you do want it kind of, you know, a bit higher, so if this is where, if the deck was right here, so you've only got these two blocks, because then the next window will be here. It's really up to you if you want to put it down deeper. There's enough of the grey to actually put it down an extra layer anyway. So I'll just quickly have a look at this and see where we can start from. Okay, so for the kind of bottom layer, what I actually started from is right here, right underneath this kind of forward gun type part. And I go one, two, three, one, two, three, and exactly the same. I'm just going to continue this pattern on a little bit more and then show you around the back. Okay, so I've just kind of ended mine here. You can continue on a little bit further. This one I actually continued on pretty much right the way to the back. So you could, if you want to, drag this all the way kind of to here, maybe, like there. That might be a good place to kind of end your actual windows. So you've got those two kind of layers. So well done on completing the USS Arizona tutorial. It has been a pretty long tutorial. It's one of my more complex ships, as well as, you know, as I spent absolutely ages on the shape, so hopefully you guys haven't got stuck in it. It is a very advanced tutorial, so well done on getting this far right to the end. Hopefully you guys have enjoyed this tutorial and you've learned a lot from it, as well as getting a really cool ship to have in your world. If you have, make sure you comment, like, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys on the next video.